30th Annual Rudy Mumley OVAC All-Star Charity Football Classic, featuring the best of Ohio as they take on the best of West Virginia. WTOB9's live coverage is brought to you in part by Trinity Health System, Whiteside Auto Dealers, Lamar, Kroger, Pepsi, Judge David J. Scarpone, Alltel, Kaufman's of Wheeling, Smitty's Wholesale Carpet Warehouse, The Health Plan, and McDonald's. And now, live from Wheeling Island Stadium, here's News 9's Bill Phillips, Kelly Alexia, and Ryan Recker.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the 30th annual Rudy Mumley OVAC All-Star Football Game from Wheeling Island Stadium. I'm Bill Phillips, along with Kelly Alexia and Ryan Recker. And Kelly, it sets up as another great evening.
Oh, it certainly does. This evening is a lot about athletics, but it's about a whole lot more for the Ohio Valley. Some of the finest athletes will take the field here in just a few moments, but we have a very talented band there out on the stage, or out on the field right now. It's going to be acting as a stage for the next couple of minutes. And then at halftime, we're going to meet the Queen of Queens candidates. So we have a lot in store tonight. But Ryan, we wouldn't be here tonight if it weren't for one man.
Right, Rudy Mumley. This is all about him tonight. He put this thing together. 30-year anniversary, but there's also a football game to be played tonight. And surrounding the football game, many questions. West Virginia, they got the ground game. Ohio has a high-powered offense. Let's take a look at a preview of tonight's game.
There's no doubt that Coach Caldwell and the Ohio All-Stars will go to the air tonight, but don't be surprised if they utilize the ground game as well.
Well, you know what? We're going to take whatever they give us. If they power up everybody in there and stop in the run, we're going to throw the ball. If they put everybody back and not going to stop the run, we're going to run the ball.
When Ohio does decide to air it out, Coach Rogers and the West Virginia defense will certainly be put to the test.
And if I had the same quarterbacks and receivers he did, I'd open up on him too. How do you defend against that? Yeah, just play your area, do the best you can. You make a mistake, don't worry about it. Play the next play.
Tonight's game features a cavalcade of stars, including Beallsville's Crhis. He gets to start at quarterback for Ohio, and he's honored to be involved in the game.
It's a great honor to get to play in this game. Good tradition here, and we got to thank a lot to Sam and Rudy Mumley for keeping this thing going, getting established. And there's a lot of people here and getting involved, and it's a lot of work, and they do a good job running it. It's an honor.
For West Virginia, the nod goes to Tyler Fike. Fike played his high school ball at Wheeling Park, and he returns to Wheeling Island Stadium to play his final game.
But playing in front of a big crowd, we have that in favor, and it's going to be a big honor playing in front of a home crowd on a home field, one last game on, you know, home field. I love that field. And
any predictions?
No, I can't get any predictions. I don't want to sound cocky. I don't want to sound not cocky, you know.
All right.
But I think some people are in for a little bit of a surprise.
All right, as you see, should be an interesting game tonight. Full complement of stars on the field. We also have a full complement of stars taking care of the game off the field tonight.
We brought everybody in tonight. We pulled out all the stops. All of the sports team is here tonight. Bill.
Well, we've got George Kellis high above the field. George, take it away.
What a departure this is, Bill, from 2 years ago when it was 97 degrees and we had to delay the start of the game for 45 minutes. Tonight's about 75. It's overcast. Ohio is on a six-game winning streak. I think this could be a good football game. Down to Don Sloan on the Ohio sideline.
Thanks a lot, George. And a word on the Ohio sideline is offense. Dave Caldwell of Beallsville is coaching the Ohio team. He loves to put it up in the air, and I think you'll see a lot of balls flying from the Ohio offense. Over to West Virginia now, and TJ Hott.
Thanks, Don. I am here on the West Virginia sideline. The West Virginia Mountaineers, of course, coached by Jim Rogers, the head coach from the Cameron Dragons, and they're wanting to put an end to a six-game losing streak that dated back to 1994. Another big story today, the starting backfield for the Mountaineers, Tyler Fike, Kyle Korn, and Dino Cardinali, all playing their final game here at Wheeling Island Stadium. Let's go back over to Bill.
TJ, thank you very much. We have our full complement of stars. Sit back, relax. We'll be back with more of the pregame show and the kickoff in just a little bit. Don't go away.
You can help support the McDonald's OVAC All-Star Marching Band this Friday, Saturday, and Sunday when you purchase a large or supersized extra value meal at a participating area McDonald's. 25 cents will be donated to the McDonald's OVAC All-Star Marching Band. Then watch as the band performs live during the OVAC All-Star Football Game July 29th on WTOV 9.
Welcome back to WTOV9's live coverage of the 30th annual Rudy Mumley OVAC All-Star Classic. They've just flipped the coin. West Virginia has elected to receive. Kelly, though, tonight a lot of other events surrounding the big game tonight as well.
We have a whole lot to bring you here tonight live exclusively on WTOV9. It all starts here in just a couple of minutes at 7:15. We got the kickoff.
Nice.
I got all my kickoff shoes.
You got your kickoff.
And we have a whole lineup of events for you, so just stay tuned and keep it here on WTOV9.
All right, now the reason we are here for tonight's game, the name Mumley, Rudy Mumley, he's the man that helped organize this game. We take a look at his impact on the All-Star game in this piece. The OVAC All-Star game has become a tremendous success, thanks to a number of people, but no one had more to do with the game's current standing than its namesake, the late Rudolph Rudy Mumley. Rudy served as the game's director for many years, but the boldest move he made on behalf of the All-Star game was his decision to mortgage his home to receive a loan to get the game started in its current form in 1972. The gamble paid off, and the game has grown to include the OVAC All-Star cheerleaders, the Queen of Queens pageant, and the McDonald's All-Star band. Rudy believed in helping others. That's why the OVAC All-Star Game not only benefits its participants, but also a number of charities. Over the past 30 years, the game has raised more than $500,000 for those charities. The OVAC All-Star Game is just a small part of what Rudy Mumley was all about. He was an educator, retiring as a principal from Buckeye South High School. He served his country in the military. But perhaps the most important thing Rudy Mumley did was love. He loved his Ohio Valley and the young men and women it produces. Because of that love, we are here tonight celebrating the achievements of the Ohio Valley's youth. We are helping others less fortunate than ourselves and remembering the man who made it possible, the late Rudy Mumley. Rudy Mumley, missed but certainly not forgotten.
Certainly not, as we're going to go ahead and pitch it over to Ryan Recker. Hey, don't forget, at halftime we have the Queening of the Queens, and then after that we have the big kick, and that's what we're all talking about tonight.
End of the third quarter, Health Plan's $10,000 kick. Paul Birchfield of Toronto will do the honors. He played in this game 20 years ago. He played for Ohio. His team won on a 35-yard field goal late in the game. He'll have a chance for $10,000 tonight from 45 yards away, so good luck to him. We'll be hoping for him to make the field goal.
And speaking of kicks, we kick off this big game here in just a matter of minutes. But first, we're going to take a little break, and we'll be back with more of our live exclusive coverage of the 30th annual Rudy Mumley All OVAC All-Star Football Classic right after this.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the 30th Rudy Mumley OVAC All-Star Football Game. Now, we do have a big football game tonight. The McDonald's marching band, the OVAC All-Star cheerleaders, and the Queen of Queens pageant. But the big winner tonight, local charities that will be helped by tonight's proceeds. And we have to thank a number of sponsors who are here to present this check for $30,000 to the OVAC. Now, the sponsors included on that list, Trinity Health System, The Health Plan, Pepsi, WTOV9, McDonald's, Smitty's Carpet, David Scarpone, Attorney at Law, Anwar Eye Center, Lamar Advertising, Kroger, and Alltel. Ladies and gentlemen, presentation of a $30,000 check to the OVAC.
And we congratulate all of our sponsors and the OVAC here tonight. Now, something that you aren't seeing tonight was a big pep rally that was held last night at West Liberty State College. That's where WTOV9's OVAC, Tom Ranisek, the OVAC Executive Secretary. You got a good look at him there, huh? WTOV9 OVAC Band Scholarship Award went to Amanda Eichelberry of Buckeye Local High School. And those recipients of the Rudy Mumley Scholarship, is a Scholar Athlete Award, a $500 scholarship, went from Ohio to Trevor Shaffer of Beallsville, and West Virginia to Justin Brownlee of Wheeling Central. In a $250 scholarship, the Terry Mowry Memorial Scholarship was awarded last night to Merrick Hughes from Ohio's team from Indian Creek High School and Brian Dick from Brooke High School on the West Virginia side. So this is all about scholarship, athleticism, and citizenship, and these were the award winners last night, but we have a whole lot more to come here tonight.
Yeah, when we come back, we're going to send it up to Bill Phillips and George Kellis. I'll join them for the call tonight. They'll get us set for tonight's game right after this.
And welcome back, everyone. It's time for the kickoff.
Yeah, we're set. All the talking's done. All the hype, all the talk's done. Time to play some football. On the call tonight, George Kellis, Bill Phillips, and myself. Let's send it up to Bill and George upstairs in the booth. Gentlemen.
Let's play ball.
All right, gang. Thanks so much. George Kellis here. Bill Phillips has arrived, but we're going to give him just a second to catch his breath. And as you can see on the field, we're ready to play some football. Just a beautiful night with a little overcast to keep the sun out of everybody's eyes. Usually the problem is that the Ohio fans have to deal with the sun in the face early in the ball game. But tonight it is just a perfect evening to watch a game like this, and we're ready to go. The Ohio All-Stars will kick off. And the ball is in the air. Merrick Hughes from Indian Creek booted it. And this is West Virginia on the return. Simon Set Cabbage of Madonna. First and 10 for the West Virginia All-Stars.
Let's take a look at the offense. Up front, good line. Maynard Brownlee, Rakoff, McCoy and Horn. Fike, Coyne, Cardinali in the backfield for West Virginia. Baxter, McCroskey, and Brown at your receivers.
And West Virginia needs to set the tempo here, Bill. They've fallen behind in a lot of these games. Come right out with a running formation, and they're in trouble in a hurry, aren't they?
Play action for West Virginia in the backfield quickly for Ohio, number 75.
And that was Jared Click from Liverpool.
Here Let's we take go. A look at the offense. Baxter McCroskey. Now we're going to go to the defense. Brooker, Jones, Amato up front on the defensive line. Phillips and Hill. Good size across the front. Good group of linebackers. Click, Ludwig, and Filtz. And your defensive backfield as we get ready for second down and long for West Virginia. Cardinali, nothing doing.
Well, the problem that West Virginia's had in this game, especially during the six-game losing streak, is matching up along the line of scrimmage. On the first play, Tyler Fike and company thrown for a loss of about 7 yards, and you can add a 2-yard loss on this play as there was great penetration right there, and they blew up the interior of the West Virginia line.
Ohio strong up front, Pepsi replay. Just started here at Wheeling Island. Fike on the outside, had a man open by a couple of steps, but overshoots the intended receiver, Jason Baxter, out of Magnolia. And it'll be West Virginia to kick the football away. And George, you mentioned it just a few moments ago, West Virginia really has to establish something early in this game. If Ohio gets rolling, they could run away with it.
Well, right off the get-go, it's three and out. In fact, minus 9 yards on West Virginia's first offensive possession. So they're going to have to come out and punt, and the Buckeyes figure to get real good field position out of this. And Ryan Recker, ladies and gentlemen, is in the box.
Jonathan Lindsay out of Payton City on to punt.
West Virginia already burns a timeout right here. So one thing, Bill, is they used to have 2 weeks of practice. Then they cut it down to 10 days. They cut it down even shorter to a week. So might be a little bit uncrisp here early.
We're going to take a timeout, back with more right after this. And welcome back to WTOV9's live presentation of the WTOV9 Game of the Week. And this week, what a game of the week, the 30th annual Rudy Mumley OVAC All-Star Football Classic. Jonathan Lindsley to punt, just gets it off. Jake Sowers will take it at midfield, and it gets on the ground, and somebody's going to come up with a turnover. Oh, West Virginia looked like they had it. It may have come free, and Ohio might have jumped on it. Three officials down in the pile, And George, as you know, that can change hands four or five times down there.
See, now that's the kind of break that West Virginia needs in a game like this. They need to get the breaks because normally Ohio will have them out manned. And they had an opportunity right there with a loose football and a muff punt, and they don't come up with it. Somebody from Ohio got out from underneath that scrum with a ball.
The reason why the punt was muffed, you see right there, two guys, Jim Amato almost getting a hand on it. So the punt rushed a little bit and then fumbled. Good coverage, though, by West Virginia.
Ryan Kittle in the backfield. Trevor Cooper goes in motion across the formation. Quarterback's going to keep, and he's going to have some yardage to the outside. Wearing number one for Ohio, that's Crhis Caldwell, and he picks up about seven on first down. And let's take a look at that Ohio offensive unit. Up front, Brown, Micah, Sherwood. Big up front, the Ohio offensive line. Pekovic and Lofton at the tackles. The backs, Caldwell at quarterback, Kittle and Cooper to start. You'll see a number of players rotated in and out. There's a look at your wide receivers as we set for second down and a long three. Cooper across the motion again, handoff inside to Kittle. He'll lean ahead, he'll be close to first down yardage. The defense, we take a look at the ends, Casanelli and Flowers, Cox and Brownlee at defensive tackle. Linebackers, Coyne and Poling. Wade and Rocchio. Fitzsimmons, Wisterman and Dick in the defensive backfield, a solid defensive backfield for the West Virginia All-Stars. Measurement down on the field, and George, as you know better than anybody today, it's a game of inches. And this one, Ohio comes up just a bit short.
Bill, it'll be interesting here to see if they keep it on that left side here. They went there two plays in a row. See if they go one more time on third and short.
Ohio with the football at the West Virginia 37. No score.
Caldwell keeps right up the middle. He'll have enough for the first down, down to the 35-yard line of West Virginia. And so far, Ohio under Dave Caldwell keeping on the ground. He's a guy that likes to throw the football around, but so far, exclusively on the ground for the All-Stars of Ohio.
Well, the one thing you don't have a lot of time to do is get timing in your passing game. So what you want to try to do in 1 week's preparation is do a lot of basic stuff. And, you know, the Beallsville Blue Devils have thrown the ball over the years, but they've also had a pretty effective running game, and Ohio's got a first down the first of the game.
Well, speak of the devil, the passing game. Up top, Materkoski with a catch inside the 10-yard line. He's down to the five, and Materkoski makes a nice adjustment back to the football, goes up top, makes the grab, and Ohio first and goal from the five.
Materkoski, the Bellaire Big Reds quarterback, converted to wide receiver early in this football game. He would be the other quarterback for Ohio in this game.
He's such a good athlete, it's tough to keep him off the field as you see his versatility here, going up and getting this ball wide open here. The ball a little bit underthrown, but he still makes a nice adjustment and makes the grab. They have first and goal just inside the 5-yard line as they call timeout here.
Clayton Fitzsimmons on the coverage, but Materkoski from Bellaire coming up with the catch. We are scoreless here at Wheeling Island Stadium. We have a timeout down on the field.
Quite a departure right there for Materkoski. There is Dave the Hat Caldwell.
I talked to Coach Caldwell the other night. He said, Bill, do you want me to go with a hat or not? And I said, usually pretty hot. The sun will be in your eyes. You'll be on that sideline that has the sun in your face. And he decided instead to go with the hat. And then instead we've got this cool weather, but he still went with the hat. I think it looks good.
I don't think that it would be Dave Caldwell without at this point in history without it. Every time I see him anywhere, he's got that.
Let's take a look at the high school preview show we'll be bringing you in just a few weeks. George Kellis will be out on the road beginning tomorrow, I believe, for the high school football previews and the 2001 preview show coming up Wednesday, the 22nd from 7 to 10, live from Undo's West in St. Clairsville, Ohio. Of course, we'll have previews of all of our teams. We'll also talk with some of the Valley's coaches as George will sit down at the interview table. And we'll also eat some pretty good food. Ryan hasn't been treated to that good food yet, so he doesn't know what he's missing yet.
You haven't had a good good Undo's spread yet.
Have not had Undo. I've asked Bill every time I work. I say, Bill, when are you taking me to Undo's? He's reluctant to take me there.
First and goal for Ohio. Kittle inside. Runs on three for about 2 yards, and he's down inside the two-yard line for the Ohio All-Stars.
Tough guy to bring down, Bill. Over 200 pounds as he battles his way inside the one-yard line, and looking like they're going to punch it in here. Look for Caldwell, maybe, with a sneak up the middle.
Checking into the ball game for the Bellaire All-Stars, Matt Materkoski. He'll split to the near side of the field. Far side, Trevor Cooper. Kittle, the lone back in the backfield behind the quarterback, Caldwell. And he's got some room right in front of the center. But he'll hand off to Kittle, and he's into the end zone and in for the touchdown. Touchdown, Ohio.
And that's where West Virginia's inability to capitalize on a loose ball following that last punt, Bill. They need to get breaks and then capitalize them on them on those themselves. Ohio got the football, good field position, march right down the field, go up 6-0.
The all-important extra point.
Surprise, guys, they didn't air it out a little bit more on that drive, but whatever works, Coach Caldwell said, we'll do whatever they give us, and they gave him the run there. It was effective.
Hughes on to attempt the extra point for Ohio. Kick is up, and the kick is good. So the Ohio All-Stars break on top in the 30th annual Rudy Mumley OVAC All-Star Classic. 7-0 here in the first quarter. With 8:10 left to go in the quarter, we'll take a timeout. Back with more right after this.
And we're back. Ohio leads West Virginia 7-0. Nothing fancy about this. Crhis Caldwell gives it off to Brian Kittle. And he just plow drives his way in from point blank range. And you can see the beef up front that Ohio sports here again, Bill. So the inside running game figures to be effective, especially with some of these backs they have, the likes of Jake Sowers out here and Kittle, another 200-pounder. They can power it up inside.
Well, the other thing we always talk about in all-star games is the luck of the bounce. And Ryan Recker, you think about it, West Virginia so close to getting a turnover and keeping the football. Instead, they lose it, and Ohio punches it in.
And as George mentioned, once again, those are the plays that West Virginia has to capitalize on. They have to hope Ohio makes mistakes. Unfortunately for them, they couldn't do it. As you see, the short kickoff here fumbled.
Short kick, Kyle Coyne. It fields the football after dropping it. Gets back on top of it, returns it out to the 23-yard line. And right now, we need to welcome in our own T.J. Haught down on the West Virginia sideline. T.J.?
Thanks, guys. You're right. West Virginia can't afford to lose situations like the fumble punt like they did. I talked to Jim Rogers. He said in order to win this game, they've got to control the clock and they've got to control the line. So far, they haven't been able to do that. They're going to make some adjustments, and they're going to try to do it again right now.
Thank you, TJ. And West Virginia will face a first and 10 from their own 23-yard line with 8:03 to go on the clock in the first quarter of play. Ohio leads it 7-0. Toby Brown goes in motion. Toby out of Cameron High School, and we've got whistles and flags all over the place down on the field. And usually in an all-star game, some timing is going to be off. And that's just the case where somebody forgot the snap count.
Can't tell if that was induced or if he jumped off.
No, I think somebody knifed in. Yeah, somebody was blitzing left of center.
That's why he forgot the snap count. He didn't know it.
Right.
I believe he wanted to get in there a little closer to hear what it was.
Dennis Nardo of Union Local, I believe, the guilty party. They're jumping off sides. First and 5 coming up.
Well, let's see what Ohio's trying to do here. It looks like they're trying to load up in the middle and try to shoot the gaps between guard and center.
Play action pass and nothing doing. Fike goes back and he's greeted by 3 Ohio All-Stars in the backfield. So far, he hasn't had any time. Tyler Hill there, along with Jim Amato. And Fike just no chance to get anything going, and the play had already broken down with a motion penalty against West Virginia.
George, as you mentioned, that's let's get the call here.
They got 5 yards on the offside penalty. There's Jimmy Rogers, who took over for Jim Potts, who was a winner in this game against Dave Caldwell. In fact, Dave Caldwell's 0-2 in this game, and he's had some trouble against guys from Marshall County. Rick Blake and company, 34-32 in a wild one back in 93, and 12 years ago in 89, it was a 22-14. One of the best West Virginia OVAC All-Star teams, I think I can recall. Jim Potts at Cameron, then the head coach, was the coach of the West Virginia All-Stars that night.
Fike to pass, looks quick across the middle, incomplete. The intended receiver, C.J. McCroskey from Wheeling Central. And we have some words, and Jim Amato's going to come in and play the peacemaker down on the field and try to get everybody settled down, but an incomplete pass for West Virginia. And George, you mentioned the 93 game. I had the pleasure of broadcasting that game, and what a wild one. Came down to the last few plays, kickoff returns for touchdowns, inside a minute to go to win that one for West Virginia. It was just a wild, wild affair.
Well, that was a night, Bill, that a lot of people left early, not anticipating the frenzied finish that would take place here.
Third down and 10 for the Mountaineers. Fike to throw, back to pass, looking to set up the screen, has a man and he overshoots him. Incomplete. Coin, the intended receiver out of Wheeling Central. It falls incomplete and will bring up fourth down and long for West Virginia.
Well, two series now for the Mountaineers, and they have net minus 10 yards of offense, and that's not good.
I'll tell you on that play, Bill, if they could have executed there, he had some running room.
Absolutely.
And a blocker in front. So not able to execute. They had the play set up, perfectly designed, but just overthrown a little bit, and they're in danger here if they don't get a good punt off of going down.
Brian Shaffer and Sowers, but the punt breaks down. He gets it off. Jonathan Lindsley kicks it out of bounds. Jonathan Lindsay, I should say, out of Payton City. We have a flag down on the play. We'll have to sort this one out.
George, that's something else along you were talking about earlier with the snap counts and whatnot. The snaps themselves also something that these teams have to work on, and it's tough executing them. They're not familiar with each other.
Well, it's a procedure call against West Virginia. That may be to their benefit, unless, of course, this would be declined. And Ohio will have great field position once again. So, yeah, you can decline that foul, and Ohio has the ball at the 34-yard line in West Virginia territory once again.
Right now, Don Sloan is going to check in from the Ohio sideline. Don?
Thanks a lot, guys. Alongside the coach, Dave Caldwell, and coach in the first drive, kept it on the ground a lot. I'd expect you to air it out a bit more.
Well, you know what? They're giving us the run. We're going to take it. If you notice, they got all those guys in the backfield, and they got these big gaps up on the line. Watch him pop through right here. Oh, guess not. Maybe I better throw it.
Maybe Coach Caldwell better put it back up. He told me before the game he'd see a lot of Kittle up the middle, and that is running back Kittle from Buckeye Trail. He scored the first touchdown. But a big key for this offense in Ohio is the center and the quarterback are both from Beallsville. A lot of all-star games, you see problems with the center snap because of unfamiliarity between the quarterback and the center. You won't see that tonight. These guys have played together for the past 3 years.
Sloan and Dave Caldwell, two of the Ohio Valley's more colorful individuals.
Well, Materkoski on the route down the sideline. He has the catch, and he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Ohio. No, they're going to say no, he wasn't into the end zone. It looked like he stretched long enough to put the ball across the goal line. A beautiful pass from Caldwell to Materkoski down to about the one-inch line. It looked like Matt Materkoski was in, to my eyes.
Well, it looked that way to me, too, Bill, but we're a long way from where he dove for the pylon. Let's take a look at this. Comment on this after the play. Caldwell does a good job. The defender got lost on the play, and good heavens.
That's a touchdown. I'll tell you what, touchdown or no touchdown, what an adjustment by Materkoski to make this play, and you know why he's out there. Pure athlete. Look at this.
And this will give us a better look.
That's a touchdown. That's a touchdown.
It sure looked that
way. You can look at it anyway. Well, that's a touchdown. Pepsi Instant Replay says touchdown. We'll see if Ohio can get it in. Caldwell says, I'll take it. And Ohio has burst into the lead with 13 points with 6:41 left in the first quarter of play.
Well, one of the interesting things that's happened here is that Crhis Caldwell is the quarterback. And, of course, he's from Beallsville. One of the problems you have, again, terminology. I think Dave Caldwell wanted to go with a quarterback, as most coaches do in this, that are familiar with what they do, you know. So that there's not a lot of confusion. Here's the extra point attempt.
Hughes' kick is up and it is good.
Materkoski would certainly like to be the quarterback in this game, and you know, I know that it has to be a real sacrifice for him not to get that opportunity, but he's contributed in a big way here for Ohio.
We'll take a timeout. WTOV9's live presentation of the 30th annual OVAC All-Star Game. Ohio leads it 14-0. Back with more after this. And welcome back to the WTOV9 OVAC All-Star Game. It's the Rudy Mumley All-Star Classic 30th year.
We've got a good officiating crew here tonight, fellas. There they are. Larry Ryan is a side gun. Jim Kaczynski, the line judge. Greg Richmond, the linesman. Bill Wilhelm is our referee. Steve DeBacco, the umpire. Frank Bland is the back judge.
Kickoff will come down. Cardinali takes it at the 10-yard line. Out across the 20. Has a seam. Has some running with one man to beat. He's tripped up. Don't know if Amato got a little piece of his foot or he just tripped up over his own feet, but he was off to the races. And I know one Mr. Hughes from Ohio was a little wobbly on those knees as he would have had to been the last man with an opportunity to stop the Wheeling Park Patriot.
Cardinali, a track star from Wheeling Park High School, only 5'7", 165 pounds, but he's got some jets in his heels.
Dave Caldwell called him the fastest kid in the valley, and we see on the Pepsi Instant Replay a clear view of that coming right into your living room, and I don't think Amato got him, Bill.
It may have just been he was trying to make a cut and went down, but a great return for West Virginia and something to cheer about. And this isn't as the ball's on the ground, but it looks like Cardinali was able to get the football. But West Virginia, they need a win. They got a win on the kickoff return. Now they need to turn it maybe not into points. We say this all the time early in football games, but at least string together a couple of first downs, show that you can move the football.
Well, if we get a chance to see that last play again, Bill, you're going to see why West Virginia's having a lot of trouble. We get a close-up right there of number 88, Dennis Nardo. But you can't see it even from that angle, but they've just got too many men to block. They've got two trying to block three between the right guard and the center right there as Ohio is blitzing. And they're disguising which direction they're coming on that blitz real well.
There's another seam, and Cardinale with about 10 yards on the play, but it'll leave him long for third down, third and about 6 or 7 yards, and that's maybe one of the ways they stay away from that defensive line that just comes rushing through, Ryan, is run the sweeps, use the misdirection, and try to get outside so they have to pursue it,
exactly.
Pursue and not just come right up
the field.
If
there's too many guys inside, then that means that they could have a mismatch somewhere on the outside, and this is what they've got to do. Good block right there.
Jerome Maynard leading the way for his teammate as it brings up third and long now for West Virginia.
Fight. Toby Brown on the carry for West Virginia. Toby Brown out of Cameron High School. He's down to the 50-yard line. He'll be short of the first down by about five, and an interesting decision here for Jim Rogers. Down 14 early. Do you go for it?
It's an all-star game, Bill, and I see no reason to be punting the ball. You're down by 14, and every time Ohio gets the ball, something bad has happened here for West Virginia. Now, they're going to try to sweep this way, and that is stuffed by the Ohio defense. West Virginia gets across midfield. The entire first quarter had been played in the other end of the field, but they will punt.
Lindsay from Peyton City back to punt. Fields a snap. Wobbly kick. Jake Sowers and Shaffer look at each other, and they let it roll inside the 10-yard line. So a lack of communication there. Shaffer and Sowers out of Cambridge and Caldwell decided, you've got it, I've got it, and they let it fall, and it cost them some yards. We'll take a timeout. Ohio on top, 14-0. 4:14 to go in the first quarter. Ohio with the football. Trinity Health System scoreboard, 14-0. Ohio back with more after this. And welcome back. Trinity Health System scoreboard, 14-0. Ohio on top. A look at, well, our own Don Sloan along with Coach Caldwell. I think Don Sloan maybe giving him some plays for this drive. You never know.
Well, they're certainly cooking, but this is the worst field position that Ohio's had so far. Clear back at their own six.
Caldwell on the keep. Will try to get to the corner. He has no place to go and takes a couple of shots on the play. And West Virginia, they had the nice return. They moved the ball a little bit. If the defense can get started, a lot of time left in this ball game.
I think Don may have called that play.
Sorry about that. Well,
Coach, last drive, you kept running the football. I told you to throw it and set up a touchdown. I think you need to do it again. That Caldwell-Materkoski connection is really getting it done. How about one more?
Right now, here it comes.
See what can happen again. The two quarterbacks, Caldwell from Bellaire, Materkoski to Bellaire, right at you.
Right at Don Sloan, and Materkoski has it. He's down the sideline. And look, the cut back. He's caught from behind, but Don Sloan, he called it, asked the coach for it. He got it, and it pays off. George, you know what?
That's unbelievable.
He may not be that upset that he's not playing quarterback tonight.
Not right now. He's getting a lot of yardage for this Ohio squad. And already this has been a lethal combination, Caldwell to Materkoski.
That's a timing thing, George. They're a two-step drop, and he just lays it out there. Once again, great execution by Materkoski, adjusting to the pass. And the West Virginia secondary.
Kittle up the middle. He'll be close to first down yardage, and I believe he has it across the 35-yard line of West Virginia. And Ohio moving the chains again. And, George, you can put them at your own 30-yard line, move them back to the 50, start them at their own 5.
Well, if they go 94,
moving the football.
Yeah, if they go 94 yards on this drive, that would not bode well for the West Virginia All-Stars. And they've gotten not only out of the hole, but they're clear down to the 34. So they've moved the ball about 60 or 70 yards here in a hurry.
And Brian Kittle from Buckeye Trail. Play action. Caldwell rolls to the West Virginia sideline. Has a man wide open and a nice catch down at the 10-yard line. Beautiful catch from Brad Wink of Martins Ferry High School. Looked like Caldwell had overshot his target, but Wink makes a nice adjustment.
Wink is certainly a rangy fellow at 6'5", 210. He was wide open, and Caldwell had all kind of running room. Get another look at this, you'll see that Caldwell has two options on this play. He could run it if he wanted to. There's nobody out here. Sees his man wide open. Look at that catch.
I'll tell you where it started, George. It started on that play action fake. He sucked that defense in and rolled out to the left and had his man wide open.
Hand off, Jake Sowers out of Cambridge looking for some running room. Good defensive play. Simon Sakavage out of Weirton Madonna coming up and just shutting down the run. Good pursuit from the West Virginia defense as Sakavage gets there and takes Sowers down. Flag on the play. And we have a clip against the Ohio All-Stars.
There's a close-up shot of Simon Sakavage from Weirton Madonna, 6 foot, 175 pounder.
Simon, little individualistic down there. He's one of the few guys with not too many decals from the other team on his helmet. He's got the big W and the L and the Bears on there, but some of these guys, I don't know how they find the room to get all the stickers on the helmets. Right now, Don Sloan, I don't know if he has stickers on his helmet. Don?
Well, Coach, what do you want to run? I mean, I've called all the big plays. I think I'll let you call one.
We're going to come back, try to hit Wink again on that crossing pattern again.
Pretty nice tight end. He's a good, tall, rangy target. You've got him and Amato, a couple nice tight ends to them.
Really, I got him. That Price boy's a good tight end also. Got good kids.
Caldwell back to pass, looking for Wink. He was open for a moment. Caldwell goes back to him, and it's almost picked off. He had him open early, couldn't get it to him, decided to go back. Good coverage from West Virginia, but he did have him open early. Good recovery by Jonathan Lindsay at Hayden City High School.
Again, you got to come up with plays when you have the opportunity to do so. A nice play by Lindsay right there to defend the pass. But if you look at this again, I think what Lindsay is probably saying to himself is, I should have had a pick right here.
Second down and 28.
Second and 28, the first down. There's a picture of Jonathan Lindsay.
Caldwell, Sowers and Kittle in the backfield. They're split. Caldwell looks to the West Virginia sideline. Puts it up. Two receivers in the same area.
Somebody for West Virginia in the secondary made a nice play right there. You see J.D. Meyer of Tyler Consolidated.
You also have on that play, George, Trevor Shaffer making a nice play as a defender, being a receiver on that play, making a defensive play as we look at the Pepsi instant replay. Caldwell, kind of an ill-advised errant pass as he fires it down there. And Shaffer on the offense actually breaks it up.
I think you got about three guys just going for the ball. We have a timeout down on the field with 1:55 to go in the First quarter play, 14-0 Ohio. There's a look at Jonathan again as Dave Caldwell talks things over with Ohio. And we will take a timeout. We will come back on the Trinity Health System scoreboard. Ohio 14, West Virginia nothing. Back with more right after this.
Good luck to all of tonight's All-Stars.
And welcome back. We go down to T.J. Hutt on the West Virginia sideline.
Thanks, Bill. We're down here with Coach Jim Rogers. Coach, you find yourself a little bit of a hole early.
Man, we got in a hole. You know, we didn't capitalize on that punt return there. We had a little bit of problem with our blocking.
What adjustments do you plan to make offensively to try to get the ball moving a little bit?
We'll try to get it on the outside now.
All right, they're going to try to get it on the outside because they're pinching on the inside. Back up to you guys in the booth.
TJ, thank you very much. Something we talked about here in the booth right now, his main concern is stopping Jake Sowers.
I would say that the number one priority is keep Ohio out of the end zone if you're West Virginia right here. You can't fall three scores behind in this game. They will now attempt a field goal of 34 yards, or about somewhere thereabouts.
Snap is down, kick is up, and Hughes has pulled it just a little bit left, so it is no good. So West Virginia with a stop, and it will remain 14-0. The Mountaineers can cheer about that as they turn Ohio away. Now the question is, can they get something started offensively and move the ball down the field?
Well, they showed signs of it in their previous drive, Bill, but they're deep in their hole in their own end here. We'll see how they respond with that.
After this play, we'll take a look at some of the games of the week coming up on WTOV9. Another great schedule. And, of course, it kicks off tonight with our live coverage of the OVAC All-Star football game. But we have much, much more coming up down the road, and we'll have a lot of fun with that throughout the high school football season. Pitch to the outside. Cardinali looking to get the corner. Does have the corner. Has the speed to get outside, and he has the speed to pick up a first down.
Good idea right there by West Virginia. Jim Rogers making a nice adjustment. You can see that there's an overload in the middle, and they are not going to permit West Virginia the inside running game. So the only way to combat that is to try to get somebody with Cardinelli's speed to the corner. And that is probably one of the most productive offensive plays in this game so far. Wait a minute, what do we got, a problem?
Just everybody a little bit slow getting up, but everybody looks to be okay. It'll be first and 10 for West Virginia from their own 31-yard line.
And if you are Ohio and you're going to allow that, you better be able to cover it, because if he breaks that corner, you can say goodbye. He's on his way to the end zone.
J.D. Meyer, number 22, checking in out of Tyler Consolidated High School. He'll split on the Ohio side of the field, near side of the field, that is. Jason Baxter from Magnolia split to the far side. Fike will have Meyer come in motion. Misdirection, whistles on the play, and I think we may have had someone jump offside or someone started a little bit too early.
I heard a whistle just as the ball was being snapped, so there's a dead ball here. Delay against the West Virginia All-Stars.
One thing you can't afford when you're down 14-0, you're starting to get your offense clicking, is a delay of game penalty, or any penalty for that matter. West Virginia will have the ball pushed back 5 yards. First and 15 now for West Virginia. Baxter comes to the near side of the field. Tyler Fike under center from Wheeling Park, used to playing on Wheeling Island Stadium as the Patriots play all of their home games here. Very comfortable surroundings. He's back to pass. Nothing comfortable about the situation he's in right now. Nothing doing for Tyler Fike. Matt Phillips from Barnesville got in quickly, big number 70, and Fike had nowhere to go.
Oh, that was the red tide coming at him right there. When you get that many pouring through, there's nothing to do, nowhere to go, and nowhere to hide. So now here is West Virginia taking another timeout.
Virtually unblocked, George, as he comes right in, grabs a hold of his shirt, and then his teammates surround him and help him out. He really didn't even get credit for the sack, even though he caused it.
Well, 7 seconds to go in the first quarter. Strange place to take a timeout, but they take a timeout with 7 seconds to go in the quarter, down 14-0. Coach Rogers talking with the West Virginia All-Stars. Hey, let's take a look at that Ohio High School and West Virginia High School football schedule, game of the week schedule, of course, for WTOV9. We have both states represented. It kicks off with Weir and Oak Glen on the 24th of August. Of course, a big one that everyone has circled around the Ohio Valley on their calendar, August 31st, Brooke and Steubenville Big Red. September 1st, we're going to double dip for everybody. Buckeye Local and Martin's Ferry, John Marshall and Bellaire. So a couple of great matchups on September 1st. And we will take a look at more of our OVAC high school football schedule in just a moment. Right now, down to TJ Haught. TJ?
Coach, what are you going to do here? Second 28.
Reverse.
They're going to run a reverse.
Simple enough.
7 seconds to go. And West Virginia lining up with a little razzle dazzle. They hope. Here comes the reverse. And here comes Toby Brown. He gets to the outside, has some running room. And Brown driven out of bounds up near the 30-yard line. Jim Amato in on the stop out of Shadyside High School.
It's a good call. They're back almost to the original line of scrimmage.
That should do it for the first quarter of play, and indeed it does. The clock has run down to triple zeros. We will take a timeout here on WTOB9 as we get ready for the second quarter of play on the Trinity Health System scoreboard. It is the Ohio All-Stars on top, 14-0 over West Virginia. Back with the second quarter right after this.
Ohio 14, West Virginia nothing. And here's another look at that reverse that kind of caught the Buckeye defense a little off guard. And they've been pursuing hard right up the middle. And once the break of the tackle right there by Toby Brown, got some pretty good yardage before he's finally driven down by Ohio's Jimmy Amato. So West Virginia still looking at third and eight even after that big gain.
Third and eight from their 32-yard line. Fike back to pass, looks downfield, and it's going to be picked off. Was it inbounds or out of bounds? It is out of bounds. On the coverage, Justin Jeffers. McCroskey, the intended receiver out of Wheeling Central. But the Barnesville Shamrock, good defensive position.
He and Matt Bettinezzi, quite a tandem for the Barnesville Shamrocks the last couple of years.
Fike pressured there. Probably that's why the ball was underthrown a little bit. Nice athletic play, and he was just close. Just, of course, in high school, only need 1 foot. Just has 1 foot on the white there. Ball incomplete, but Ohio will get the ball back.
Wobbly kick. It'll be Shaffer from Caldwell taking the punt. Bobbles it, has it, picks it up, and he's across the 45, and he'll give Ohio good field position out at about the 47-yard line.
So far in this game,
Ohio will take over first and 10.
So far in this game, even when something bad happens for Ohio, they wind up with something good.
Twice now fumbled punts and recover them. So the ball bouncing the way of Ohio as we take a look at it once again on the Pepsi instant replay.
Trevor Shaffer splitting the far side of the field. Materkoski to the near side. Wink on the far side of the offensive line at tight end. Sowers and Kittle still in the backfield, as is Caldwell, and the left-hander looking for his favorite target tonight. Matt Materkoski has another first down out at the West Virginia 40-yard line. He's been 4-for-4 on attempts at wide receiver.
You can see the chemistry, Bill. They've worked a lot this week in practice, and you can see they're just, it's just a mind game. They know where the ball's going to be, and Materkoski knows that Caldwell's going to put it there for him. He's just getting open and making the catches.
First and 10 now for the Ohio All-Stars from the 40-yard line. Nick Shanks splits to the far side of the field out of St. Clairsville. Handoff inside Kittle. He's wrapped up after a short gain on the bottom of the pile for the West Virginia Mountaineers. Number 88, Aaron Poling out of Cameron High School.
They're using their weapons here, Bill. Materkoski, Kittle, they're mixing everyone in. Jake Sowers has had his complement of carries, so we knew coming in that West Virginia would have their hands full, and we're seeing that firsthand right here.
Materkoski splitting the far side. Kittle will leave the backfield. Now Materkoski comes back to the near side, where he will line up along with Trevor Shaffer in a slot formation to the near side. Second down and 8. Pitch to Sowers. He's got Fitzsimmons, and he will be wrapped up.
A lot of other Mountaineers. Good job just to keep him contained back there till the posse arrived.
Clayton Fitzsimmons came up quickly and forced the pitch to the outside Interesting face match there.
Fitz, one of five members of the Wheeling Central Maroon Knights state champions. In fact, one curious thing about this West Virginia roster, Bill, is that 17 of the 31 players are from Class A schools. No one from John Marshall here represented in this game tonight, which is a little unusual.
Third and long, Caldwell to throw. Flanker screen, Shanks has it, but he is wrapped up at the line of scrimmage. Good coverage from West Virginia.
Flag on the play as well.
Linebackers not fooled on the play. Kevin Cox from Weir in on the play for West Virginia defensively. Flag down on the field.
Holding on Ohio.
Against Ohio.
Bill, this game had the makings of a blowout, but on back-to-back possessions, West Virginia has stopped Ohio on third down, so their defense sticking tough when they have to.
And that's the thing. You have to. If the defense can keep you close, you have a chance. If they go into the half and they're only down 14, there's a long way to go in this quarter. They still have a chance in this ball game. If they get down three scores, they still have a chance, but it starts to get a little bit dim and the confidence really starts to go down. You make some defensive stops and a few offensive plays, it's going to bode your emotions, and that might get you going. Don Sloan?
Coach, you're at the 41. Good time for a fake, maybe?
Yeah, we're going to run the fake punt pass here. Hopefully it's open. Hopefully they're going to come after it and try to make something, and we'll get a guy open.
Materkoski, the punter for Ohio. He's Bellaire's quarterback. You've seen him tonight on the receiving end of it. Looks like he may get a chance to put one up. Delay of game call, though, against Ohio. Coach, does that change your call at all? He's thinking.
Merritt, go kick it.
I guess that does change his call. Coach, not quite the riverboat gambler I thought he was. 5 yards, that's not that much. Why change the call, Coach?
I wanted to see them try that. That would have been fun to watch.
He's got to go 18 instead of 11. All right, they're going to kick it this time, guys. Back to you.
Well, we're going to have another penalty against Ohio on the outside. It looked like Trevor Shaffer jumped the gun a little bit. Trevor wearing number 20 on the outside.
Officiating crew busy tonight.
You know, I talked to the officiating crew, and I said, you know, if you guys keep those flags in your pockets, but that was a pretty obvious jump on the outside. George, take this opportunity. This opportunity to congratulate you and the Ohio Valley Greyhounds for a great season. I know you came up a game short of where you wanted to be next week in the NIFL championship game, but what a great run you took the Valley on this year.
Well, I appreciate it, Bill, and, you know, we're still going to keep plugging away until we achieve that goal.
Short kick, and it will go out of bounds at the 31-yard line, and that's where West Virginia will take over, first and 10. We will take a timeout on the Trinity Health System scoreboard. 9-12 to go in the second quarter of play. Ohio on top, 14-0. Back with more after this.
Trinity Health System is now the clear choice for cardiac care with the opening of the Trinity Heart Center. Phase one of the newly remodeled Trinity Heart Center is complete. Phases two and three will open later this summer, offering cardiac intervention and open heart surgery for the first time in the Steubenville-Wharton area. Pittsburgh's premier heart surgeons will work right here at home. Our heart has been in it for over 30 years, so put your heart in the right place. Trinity Heart Center.
WTOB 9 would like to thank these sponsors for their support of our live coverage of the 2001 Rudy Mumley OVAC All-Star Football Classic. Trinity Health System, Whiteside Auto Dealers, Lamar, Kroger, Pepsi, Judge David J. Scarpone, Alltel, Kaufman's of Wheeling, Smitty's Wholesale Carpet Warehouse, The Health Plan, and McDonald's. Good luck to all of tonight's All-Stars.
And welcome back to Wheeling Island Stadium, WTOB9's live exclusive coverage of the 30th annual Rudy Mumley OVAC All-Star Football Classic. Bill Phillips, George Kellis, Ryan Recker, Don Sloan, and TJ Haught down on the field. And of course, we also have Kelly Alexia here and a cast of thousands bringing you the sound and pictures. And the picture right now shows West Virginia on the ground, trying to sweep it outside, something that their coaching staff said they wanted to do, George and Ryan, was get it outside because Ohio was too strong coming up the front.
Now it looks like Ohio's made some outside adjustments, too.
Well, what we have coming up here, we have the Fall Brawl, November 10th, 2001. That's this year at St. John Arena in Steubenville. First annual Fall Brawl, open to Ohio, open to wrestling tournament, grades K through 12, Ohio and West Virginia. Everybody's welcome to come. George Kellis and Ryan Recker apparently will square off in a death match in that one, and we'll have to wait and see if that's actually a part of the Fall Brawl.
A cage match.
Second down, not much doing for West Virginia. TJ Hott, what do you have for us?
Thanks, Bill. Justin Brownlee from Wheeling Central on the previous punt return hit helmet to helmet with somebody from the Ohio All-Stars. They were just checking him out, seeing a little bit of lights and stuff in front of his eyes. They're saying right now it's just a ringer. They're not sure if it's a concussion. They're going to keep an eye on him for a minute before they send him back in. But he wants to go, so we'll see what happens, Bill.
TJ, thank you very much. So we'll keep an eye on that situation, Justin Brownlee.
Where did he go?
Answering some telephones right now. Hopefully he'll be all set. Tyler Fike across the middle, and it is incomplete. Intended receiver on the play, Jason Baxter, but good coverage from Ohio. It falls incomplete. It'll bring up fourth down.
That would have been a blow to West Virginia's interior front with Brownlee out. 6 feet, 215 pounds. He's back in the ballgame.
Good news there. Just a little bit of a shot to the head. Knocked him a little loose for a second, but he's got his faculties back together, and he's ready to go on the punt coverage team.
Jake Sowers
back deep to return the kick, along with Brian Shaffer.
Jonathan Lindsay set the punt.
High wobbling kick. Sowers will call for a fair catch. Ball's on the ground, but Shaffer recovers as the cover man, Simon said Cabbage, was blocked into Sowers. Ball's on the ground, but it'll be Ohio football. First and 10 with good field position for about their own 37-yard line.
Dave Caldwell cannot be too happy with his punt return unit. Three times they fumbled the ball tonight. Fortunately for he and his team, they've recovered all three, and West Virginia cannot catch a break and recover one of those fumbles. Still 14-0 in favor of Ohio. And midway through the second. I'll tell you something else. As long as West Virginia hangs around in this ballgame and remains in striking distance, Dave Caldwell's got to be kind of nervous down there that his team has not capitalized on the opportunities they've had.
Trevor Cooper comes up with the carry on first down. He picks up about 4 yards on the play. Second down and six. Trevor Cooper out of Indian Creek. Fantastic senior season for
okay,
Trevor
Coach,
Cooper. Don, down to you.
Coach, I'd like you to do something. We've seen Caldwell throw to Materkoski. How about Materkoski throwing back to Caldwell?
Come on. Not yet.
You know what? Let me see what we do here. I don't want to do any too much trickery here and get us in trouble.
You know what? You're afraid if I make one more good call, you'll have to have me on Friday nights
check
this year.
Check it.
We're going to check it, whatever that means. I guess that's an audible. Here we go.
Pretty soon he's going to tell slow.
I could make this call all night.
Caldwell outside. Materkoski with a catch. He's taken down at the 23-yard line. Big reception for the Ohio All-Stars, and it's a big first and 10.
Bill, unofficially his fifth catch tonight, and they've all been big ones. This one setting up Ohio deep in West Virginia territory as we look at the Pepsi Instant Replay. Once again, the connection Caldwell to Materkoski for big yardage.
Ball on the 23-yard line.
And that is good coverage.
Yeah, here's a guy, Bill, that stood out. What was it? Which All-Star game? Was it the North-South game in Ohio? It was one of them. Here, that of the big 33. I think it was a North-South game, and Materkoski had just a terrific performance in that game.
Good pass, good catch, and the defense pretty solid. That's pretty good coverage. We have a timeout called by Ohio, and we don't know yet if
who
it'll be
Materkoski. Who called that timeout? Dave Caldwell or Sloan?
We'll take a timeout and see what play Don Sloan has for us when we come back. On the Trinity Health System scoreboard, 14-0 Ohio. Back with more after this.
Well, we're back on the Ohio sidelines. 14-0 Ohio leading, and Coach, you're going to try my play now.
We're going to throw your play in right now. We're going to throw one from Materkoski to Caldwell.
I think Sloan is going to wind up in the Hall of Fame in Canton with some of these calls he's making.
on the stop with the bow to the ears.
I'll tell you what, Don Sloan is calling one heck of a game down on the Ohio sideline.
Quite torn up.
Oh, for crying!
See? A double pass. See?
Does he have money on this
game? One yard. What do we got going, Coach?
Quick pitch with Trevor, Cooper around the right side.
Oh, that's too easy. No, maybe Ooh. Not. Maybe not.
Trevor Cooper on the carry.
Making the stop.
Well, you know what's great about this game, WIVM in Canton, Ohio has come aboard as we take a look at the fall brawl. And there's WIVM 52 in Canton. And why not start as it's Hall of Fame week in Canton, Ohio. We'd like to welcome all our viewers in Canton, Ohio and the surrounding area that pick up WIVM to our OVAC All-Star Football Game, of course, the 30th annual Rudy Mumley All-Star Football Classic. Thanks for watching. We thank everybody that picks us up every night. Kittle wide open, but why not go to the man in the back of the end zone for a touchdown? Brad Wink, touchdown, Ohio. And we've got a penalty for excessive celebration, but you know what? It's an All-Star game. It's supposed to be fun.
That was a nice little two-step there by Brad Wink after the reception. I like that.
The dance was maybe as nice as the play as it was set up. Wink wide open in the back of the end zone. As we take a look at the Pepsi instant replay, Caldwell on the play action fake. Just lofts it up there, and Wink comes down with it, making sure he's got his foot in. He's got both feet in. That's a touchdown. Martins Ferry graduate, Brad Wink, putting Ohio up 20-0.
You could see the replay there. Kittle from Buckeye Local went out, and he was running a little out pattern at about the 10-yard line. He was wide open. So Caldwell with two options. He decides to go with Wink. They had both receivers open. And they put it in the back of the end zone for a touchdown. It's 20-0 with 5:05 to go here in the first half. Hughes on to attempt the extra point. Spot up. We're going to go for two. Shanks looking to throw, dumps it off to Kittle, doesn't have enough blockers, and he will be stopped. So it'll remain 20-0, Ohio on top of West Virginia. We will take a timeout. The Trinity Health System scoreboard, 20-0. The Buckeyes over the Mountaineers. Back with more after this.
All-Stars.
Welcome back to Wheeling Island Stadium, 20-0, as you see on the Trinity Health System scoreboard. Another look at the touchdown from the reverse angle. Caldwell up top to Brad Wink for the touchdown, putting Ohio up 20-0 as Wink wide open in the back of the end zone off the play action fake. So Ohio going to the air and sticking to it. That's what's been most effective. Materkoski with five catches and a long catch there set up that touchdown.
Wink with a couple of touchdown reception and a nice catch down at the 10-yard line earlier in the first quarter. So the big star right now would have to be Caldwell because he is hitting everybody. He's not missing many of his targets tonight as Hughes gets ready to kick off to West Virginia with 5:05 to go in the second quarter of play. Good, strong kick, booming kick back into the end zone, and it'll be down there and it'll come out to the 20-yard line. Clayton Fitzsimmons from Wheeling Central says, why not? I would have run it back. I know another guy that would have run it back in his day, T.J. Haught for Tyler. T.J., what do you have from Coach Rogers?
Thanks, Bill. Coach, 5 minutes left. You're going to try to get one on the board. What are you going to do?
We're going to spread them out in front of them.
All right.
First down and 10, ball on the 20-yard line.
Well, he keeps it simple. He asked them earlier, the reverse, and now they're going to try to go up top and see what they can do here.
Well, I think they're going to have to get some things developed quickly. I think it's going to have to be some short drops and get rid of the football. Because whenever Fike has dropped deep back in the pocket, they've gotten some pressure on him.
Fike to throw, across the middle. Toby Brown in and out of his hands. Takes a shot for his troubles from Don Price out of Toronto, the linebacker. It's incomplete. It'll bring him second down. A little bit behind the intended receiver. But I'll tell you what, if you talk to Toby Brown right now, I'd say I should have made that catch. Now, Toby's got a number of decals on that helmet. He managed to squeeze a few on there. TJ.
Coach, we're going to go incomplete pass, first down. What are you going to try to do second down?
We're going to throw it again. We've lost our composure. It was wide open. We should have had that.
Jim Rogers is not looking happy.
Well, Coach Rogers, and that's one of his players. So he knows Toby pretty well, and he thinks the team's starting to lose its composure a little bit. We'll have to see if they can regain some here on second down. Fike across the middle. And Clayton Fitzsimmons comes up with a nice catch. He takes a pop in the ribs from Jake Sowers out of Cambridge High School. Short gain on the play, a couple. It'll bring up third and long. And one thing about Clayton Fitzsimmons, member of a high school state championship team with Wheeling Central, he was featured for his efforts. He had five touchdowns that game. Big day receiving, big day catching the football and rushing the football. He was in Sports Illustrated's Faces in the Crowd, so he had a big senior season.
Well, he certainly did. And Wheeling Central just had a great year. Jim Thomas winning his second state title, 1979, and again in 2000.
Nice pop. There's
Jake Sowers, who can do it on both sides of the football, the Cambridge Bobcat.
Nice pop by Sowers there, George. As you mentioned, and Ohio's going to give West Virginia those underneath routes. They're not going to give them anything big as a timeout is called on the field.
4:15 to go in the first half of play. It's 20-0 Ohio. We're going to stay right here as head coach Jim Rogers talks things over with the Mountaineers. And, of course, on the Ohio sideline, Don Sloan drawing up defensive schemes for Coach Caldwell and the rest of the staff.
They start.
Now, coming up a little bit later on this month, in just about a week, a big special coming up here on WTOV9. We'll take a look at Maz and Swan, a call to the hall, as we take a look at Bill Mazeroski and Lynn Swan as they get ready to go into the Hall of Fame. Pittsburgh Pirate, Pittsburgh Steeler, heading to the Hall of Fame, one in Canton and one in Cooperstown.
Two good hands guys, to say
the
least.
Oh, real good hands guys. The best.
Well, here is West Virginia on third down and about six.
And both could turn a pirouette at second base. And
a pirouette.
Yes.
Yes.
Fike to throw. Pressure gets it off down the middle, and it's going to be picked off. Jeffers on the interception. He'll be dragged down from behind at the 36-yard line, and we have a flag on the play. But this one, and another flag comes in late as some of the players down on the field starting to jaw a little bit, but a big catch there and a turnover for West Virginia and Ohio in business again.
You want to credit Adam Jones, Bill, with the pressure there for Ohio, forcing Fike to throw that ball up for grabs. And then it was picked off, and we'll sort out the penalty here.
Remind everybody, we are live on WTOV9, bringing you the 30th annual OVAC All-Star Game. And, of course, we're excited about tonight's contest and, of course, all of our games coming out throughout the season as we take a look at the Barnesville Shamrock. Who has come up with the interception. It will remain Ohio football. We'll just have to find out exactly where he will get it.
Well, Justin Jeffers, and that is the correct pronunciation of that young man right there. As a junior, they had one whale of a team that went to the postseason. And Jeffers, and I mentioned earlier, Matt Bettinezzi, who certainly would have been just another weapon had he been here in this game for Ohio. He is not on the roster. Jeffers makes the interception. I have no idea exactly where the foul took place on this. That's against Ohio, and it's after the fact. So Ohio will get the football, I think.
Want to remind everybody, coming up in just a few moments, we will have the OVAC Queen of Queens pageant winner announced at halftime here. We will also take a look at the McDonald's All-Star Marching Band. So a lot coming up at halftime, and of course coming up after the third quarter of play, $10,000 on the table for Paul Birchfield from Toronto, Ohio, a player in this game for the Ohio All-Stars 20 years ago.
Bill, the West Virginia team still has the football, so two penalties called against Ohio on that play gives West Virginia some life here. I don't know. The interception was nullified. And then there was a personal foul on top of it. So instead of being Ohio's ball in West Virginia territory, all of a sudden West Virginia now has a second down and about seven at the 47.
Well, I apologize to Justin Jeffers because I said he could keep the football. Apparently the official said no and took it away from him.
How big of a boost would this be for West Virginia to punch one in here before the half?
Nick Hall split to the outside along with Toby Brown. Brown will come in motion. Pitch to the outside, not much. maybe a half a yard.
Well, he had some blockers, George. I'm sure you saw that on the outside, and he decided to cut it back in. He may have been able to turn the corner there and head for the sideline. Nonetheless, third and long coming up for West Virginia.
TJ?
Coach, the clock's running. You're going to try to get it in the air. What are you going to do?
Where's Baxter at?
Where's Baxter? I guess they don't have the right guys in there right now. They're trying to get him in. Who are you going to go to now?
You're wide out here.
Fike to throw. Has some time. Across the middle, double coverage. Cardinals in of quarterbacking. Don't go late across the middle. Good coverage from Ohio. Incomplete. Intended receiver, Nick Hott, number 28. Nick out of Bishop Donahue High School. Falls incomplete. Will bring a fourth down. And
Ohio's been able to adjust to everything West Virginia's tried to do on offense here, fellas. They came out with the strategy they're going to stop the inside run, and they did that. Then West Virginia had a couple of plays. They ran to the outside. Now eventually they've cut that off. And everywhere that Fike tries to throw the football, there's a defender. So the West Virginia offense is run aground here.
And he's been rushed all night by blitzing linebackers and defensive ends and just about everything else. As there's a fake punt.
Short snap. Clayton Fitzsimmons out to about the 40-yard line. It'll be very, very close.
No, he's a yard short. He needed to get to the 40, and he only got to the 41.
That's going to be close. That's going to be very close.
Don Price in on
the sticks on the far side of the field, not quite to the 40-yard line. All depends on the spot, which, of course, there's a good look at Clayton out of Wheeling Central, state champion. Let's take a look at this. Del Barris right on top of it, and it doesn't look like he has it. They stretch the chain, and he's short by about a foot and a half.
Good eyes, George.
Take another look at it. Good play.
That was a good spot, too. I mean,
and Don Price came up and really made that play. Didn't allow Clayton to stretch out and put the football out a little bit further as Price comes up from Toronto and makes the play. And, of course, Don Sloan right down there with the chain gang. He was ready to mark the football. And Don, what's going on? What do you have for
All right. 2:16 left in the half, Coach. What do we got? First and 10 on your own 41.
Throwing the ball.
Well, that doesn't surprise me, but to who?
We're going to go to either Materkoski or Shaffer on the outside.
Caldwell to throw. Get some pressure. He's not going to throw on this one. He is wrapped up. Aaron Poling, number 88, came firing in from his defensive end position out of Cameron, and he was the first one to get there. And I don't know if that's Aaron's girlfriend's name across his helmet, but he has a big Lauren across the helmet. I'm assuming that's not a name of a high school that we've missed the last few years. I'm assuming that it's a girlfriend or maybe his mom or sister. We take another look at it.
12-yard loss.
If it's not his girlfriend, he could be in trouble.
Well, this next play that we're about to see here is a mess with
Ryan
a penalty
Scott.
Marker to boot.
Ryan Scott also in on the pressure on Caldwell back on first down.
An offensive pass interference on a short pass route.
West Virginia indicating they will decline. Justin Brownlee from Wheeling Central, defensive captain. He's doing all the talking with the officials. He says we'll decline the football. We'll leave it right here, and we'll go at him on second down.
You know, guys, with all of Ohio's Ohio's offensive success here early on, we have not heard on the offensive side of the ball from Trevor Shaffer. It's been called well to Materkoski. Interesting to see if they'll try to get him into the mix here.
.143 to go.
Boy, this is third and forever. Got to get past midfield for a first down.
Handoff to Trevor Cooper, little handoff. He hurdles one tackler. He's out to the 20-yard line. It'll be well short of the first down. They'll bring up a long fourth down situation, and Ohio look to kick the football away as the clock rolls inside of 1 minute to go in the first half.
West Virginia,
half
I think they have one timeout left.
From the stadium scoreboard, indications are that no timeouts remain for either ball club as we take a look at the all-star cheerleaders from the Ohio squad. And they are ready to go. A young cheerleader. Everybody happy, and why not? The Ohio cheerleaders, their club up 20-0. Smitty's Carpet, the sponsor on that, as Jason Baxter will take it at the 35-yard line for West Virginia. A lot of red jerseys he's seeing in front. Now he gets a block, and he's finally taken down at the 40-yard line. A whole lot of running for not much yardage. And with 28 seconds to go, West Virginia will have a first and 10 from their own 40-yard line as they trail it 20-0 here in the first half of play. Coming up at halftime in just a few moments, we'll have the crowning of the Queen of Queens. And we'll also take a look at the All-Star Marching Band. And a little bit later on, we'll also have our $10,000 kick at the end of the third quarter.
Also want to remind everyone tonight coming up on Sports Sunday right here on WTOV 9, full recap of the game, highlights, and post-game reaction, and also the result of the $10,000 kick, as well as the Queen of Queens winner. So we'll recap the entire night coming up tonight after News 9 at 11.
A little screen pass, wrong side, and Fike a lot of pressure and just didn't have time to really set up and find his man. Behind the intended receiver, it'll bring up second down and 10 from the 40-yard line with 24 seconds to go in the first half of play.
You know, I think Jim Rogers at halftime is going to be disappointed he's down 20-0, but even more so because of the fact that his offense can't get into any continuity, can't get any flow going here, which is obviously part of the reason why they're down by 20 points.
Well, I've got a theory. I'll give it to you
over to their sideline. Fike back to pass. Off the back foot, Toby Brown can't hang on, and it would be tough catch as Shaffer came up and gave him a pop right in the mouth. It's incomplete, it'll bring up third down. Don, that's truly a compliment because you've been right on so far.
Well, I thought it was too defensive too quick. Just don't ask me to coach defense.
Well,
but I'll tell you what, Coach Call, they've really been clicking on offense, and I'm very impressed by Materkoski as a receiver. You'd think Caldwell and Materkoski have been playing together for years.
I'll tell you what's the most impressive thing I've seen in this game is Ohio's defense. They got an answer for everything.
Fike, got the big hogs up front.
Well,
the job
Fike is getting pressured. When the receivers are out there, as you saw in that last play, somebody's there to stick them as soon as the ball arrives.
Matt Phillips, Jared Click, along with Tyler Hill on the Ohio defensive side of the football, right up front in that interior line, and they have been a disruptive force for the Ohio All-Stars, and the West Virginia offensive line has to be thinking, what do we do with these guys? They just keep coming and coming and coming, and we can't hold them out. 18 seconds to go, third and 15 for West Virginia. They trail it 20-0. Fike to throw outside, and it is picked off. Picked off, and Roy turning it down the sideline is Trevor Shaffer, number 20, and Shaffer down to the 30-yard line, and the clock will stop with 5 seconds to go, and Ohio perhaps an opportunity to throw one into the end zone here at the end of the first half of play. So an overthrown pass, and Trevor Shaffer from Beallsville comes up with the INT.
Ohio only rushed four on that play, Bill, but still got to Fike as we look at the Pepsi instant replay. Still got a little bit of pressure on him, enough to make him throw this errant pass, and it was picked off by Trevor Shaffer playing safety on the play.
Shaffer does a good job on the return of keeping his balance. Looked like he might go down early, just out of control as he runs. As Hughes tries the field goal from long distance, and he may have $10,000. No, he had a long enough leg, but just a little bit left, but he gave it a good effort as time runs out here in the first half of play. Ohio will leave the field here at Wheeling Island Stadium on top, 20-0. When we come back, we will have halftime festivities from the 30th annual Rudy Mumley OVAC All-Star Classic right after this.
Good evening, Ohio Valley. I'm Kelly Alexia from WTOV 9. Who's ready to find out who the queen is?
I am.
Bill Phillips is ready. Bill Phillips is ready, so we are all ready. Let's get it started with the Miss Congeniality, which will be presented tonight by Mr. Donald Martin of the Osiris Shrine, and he is the potentate. If we could have you step there and present Miss Congeniality to Natalie Votov, Weirton Madonna High School. Natalie Votov, Weirton Madonna High School, Miss Congeniality for the year 2001.
Ladies and gentlemen, representing McDonald's, Ross Stoltz, he will present our fourth runner-up. The fourth runner-up from Martins Ferry High School, Amy Dunn.
That's our fourth runner-up, Amy Dunn from Martins Ferry High School. Congratulations. And up next, we announce our third runner-up. This award will be presented by Jerry Cook of Pepsi. Ladies and gentlemen, your third runner-up for the Queen of Queens 2001, Lindsay Moore, Union Local High School. Lindsay Moore, Union Local High School. Bill?
Kelly, representing our second runner-up, Judge David J. Scarpone. The second runner-up from John Marshall High School, Lacey Williams.
The second runner-up, Lacey Williams of John Marshall High School. Now to the first runner-up, which will be presented by Jim Stein of the Health Plan. Ladies and gentlemen, your first runner-up for the Queen of Queens 2001, Crystal Prandtl, Brooke High School, first runner-up. From Brooke High School, first runner-up, Crystal Prandtl. Bill, are you ready for this?
I think I'm ready. Is everybody ready for the Queen of Queens 2001?
Can we hear you out there? I think they're ready, Bill. You ready?
I am ready.
Okay.
Presenting the Queen of Queens, Bernie Kaufman from Kaufman's of Wheeling. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2001 Queen of Queens. From St. John Central High School, Stephanie Jingle.
Jingle, crowned by the 2000 Queen of Queens, Chrysaline Barone of Brooke High School. So we want to hear what the Queen has to say about this. What do you think, Stephanie Jingle, of this award?
At least I can calm down now. It's such an honor to be recognized for all my time and years that I've put into this. To get ready for this day.
Let's see your award one more time. Your 2001 Queen of Queens for the OVAC, sponsored by Kaufman's of Wheeling, Stephanie Jingle of St. John Central High School. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I need all the girls everywhere.
Ohio 20, West Virginia nothing. And one of the great highlights of this annual event is the presentation at halftime by the McDonald's All-Star Band. Youngsters represented by OVAC schools everywhere, and they are ready to perform. It ought to be some kind of a show.
Thank you. Thank you.
Take a timeout here on WTOV 9. Ohio on top of West Virginia at the half, 20-0. Back with the second half of play right after this. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to WTOV 9's live coverage of the 30th annual Rudy Mumley OVAC All-Star football game. In the first half, it was all Ohio. The Ohio All-Stars leading West Virginia 20-0. Bill Phillips along with George Kellis, Don Sloan, TJ Hutt down on the sideline. Ryan Recker has headed back up the road to Steubenville for tonight's Sports Sunday telecast. And, of course, Kelly Alexia down on the sideline. She was down on the field with our Queen of Queens and the McDonald's All-Star Marching Band, and she'll be joining us again with the $10,000 kick at the end of the third quarter. But, George, we have some first half highlights, and let's take a look at that as we go through these again. And here you have Kittle from Buckeye Local going in for the first touchdown. Brian Kittle, number 46, from Buckeye Trail. Brian Kittle from Buckeye Trail with the touchdown. That made it 6-0. Buckeye Trail fullback. Crhis Caldwell, Matt Materkoski. George, these guys have hooked up a few times.
Five times in the first half. Materkoski, five receptions, 159 yards. That could have been a touchdown. Looked awful close.
Ruled down at the one-inch line, so Crhis Caldwell decided, you know what, I'll just take it in myself, and Caldwell's played a nice first half.
Caldwell completed 8 of 10 passes for 199 yards, scored that TD right there, and caught a pass from Materkoski, so it's been a pretty good strategy as we look now at the last Ohio touchdown.
Brad Wink from Martins Ferry on the receiving end of this Caldwell pass. He hauls it in, and you get a little left-handed spike, and you know what? If you're back there, you might as well do a little dance. And he gives us a little dance.
Get down tonight for Brad Wink.
And that made it 20-0. That dance and spike of the football resulted in a flag for excessive celebration, and that would push Ohio back, and they would miss the extra point. But right now, that extra point seemingly won't matter in this ball game as they lead it 20-0. But, of course, we'll have to wait and see because a lot of football to play. T.J. Hutt down on the sideline, and he has Coach Rogers. T.J., what are they going to do?
Coach, you're down 20-0, but you got the whole second half. What'd you tell the team at halftime?
The only thing we got to do, they're taking our trap game away with us. Whether they're playing that inside with their nose and their linebacker to cover up our guards, they're just telling us we can't run the trap, forcing us to the outside. So we're looking going to the outside with this ball. We're going to throw a little bit shorter pass routes, try to get our line to pick up, and let Tyler get the ball off.
Defensively, the two biggest guys they've got are both of their quarterbacks, Materkoski and Caldwell. Right. Both been hurting you. What are you going to do this half?
Okay, we played pretty darn good coverage. Just the fact that Crhis is throwing the ball real well. He's got that fade pass a couple times there. Hey, we just got to suck it up.
All right, good luck, Coach. Right. Bill, George.
TJ, thank you very much. Captains out at midfield. Of course, captains. representing their specialties, special teams, defense, offense. Donnie Price, one of the captains for Ohio. Gentlemen, the fan wanted me to make sure I mentioned that he was one of the captains for tonight's game, and he's played a solid ball game so far. He's come up with a couple of big hits defensively. So the captain's talking things over. Now in the first half, West Virginia received the kick this half. They will defend the goal, and Ohio will get the ball first. A guy that's been all over the football offensively so far is our Don Sloan, and he's down on the Ohio sideline. Don?
Yeah, thanks a lot. A lot of good play calling, and thanks my play calling. The cheerleaders from Ohio have had a lot of cheer about. You guys having fun tonight? I think that's a yes. The cheerleaders tonight, sponsored by Smitty's Carpet Warehouse in Steubenville. And you guys want to try a cheer for us?
Yes! Yeah. Yeah.
Fire away.
N-A-C-H-O, Nacho, Nacho Man!
All right, we'll take back to you guys up top.
Don, thank you very much. And Don Sloan has called a heck of a game.
And
right now, hey, equal time.
So, at some point in the third quarter, Dave Caldwell is going to be tied up and gagged back in the locker room. And TJ Hott, back to you, and Sloan's going to be calling a play.
TJ?
All right, thanks, George. We're down here with the West Virginia cheerleaders, of course, brought to you by Smitty's Carpet. And they have a little something they'd like to say back to the Ohio cheerleaders. Girls? Okay, Bill, George.
TJ, thank you very much. We are getting ready for the second half kickoff. George?
I'll tell you what, Bill. We have to mention that unbelievable performance by the McDonald's band at halftime. Those kids work maybe harder even than the football players for this event, because football players put in a week of practice. But these kids work very hard at this thing as we get the second half kickoff. But every year it just seems like it gets better and better. And it's just a magnificent performance.
Well, you mentioned the football players getting about 10 days or so, roughly, to get their game plan in and get ready to go as a team. The McDonald's All-Star Band didn't report to training camp until Wednesday night. So they had Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. They perform on Sunday. So
how can they get all that prepared?
They're All-Stars.
Ball the 27-yard line.
And they put on a great show. Congratulations to all the McDonald's All-Star Band selections. They did a great job, and right now we are back to football here in the third quarter, and we've got a former All-Star getting ready, loosening up his leg as we go up top to start the second half, and it's incomplete on first down. We have second down and 10 from the 28-yard line. Paul Burtsfield, he played in this game about 20 years ago, and Ohio won on a 35-yard field goal. We'll be down on the field trying a 45-yarder.
What about the irony of that? There's Dave the Hat.
His coach.
I almost said I ought to call you the Cat in the Hat. You like that?
The Cat in the Hat was a pretty sly fellow, wasn't he?
What are you doing?
Talk to me. Throwing it.
Caldwell wide open. Brad Wink overshoots, and Wink takes a little bit of a pot. Coming in and making the hit, Brian Dick out of Brooke High School. I don't think the hit was as big as it looked, but Brad Wink was open for a moment. Crhis Caldwell did a nice job of buying some extra time.
Maybe it's just me, but I do think it's added a touch of entertainment this year, having Sloan and Dave Caldwell chirp at each other.
Dave Caldwell, a sly fellow. Third down and long for Ohio from the 28. Swing it back, and it's Jake Sowers on the near sideline. Tries to dance around a defender. Can't do it. It'll bring a fourth down. And West Virginia comes out quickly with a nice defensive stand.
Real nice. That looked like a real swarming unit getting after it right there. So the good thing for West Virginia is their players have come out with some renewed energy here in the third quarter. Sometimes you're down 20 to nothing, you just come out, you're lethargic, and you just keep getting snowballed. But give them a lot of credit right there, because that netted about 1 yard, if no, 0 yards. Ohio did not
Jason
make any
Baxter
hay there.
back to return the kick. Ball will bounce at the 45-yard line. He's going to let it roll, and that is something that will drive special team coaches a little bit nuts, because if he picks that up, he saves about 5-6 yards on the play. Let it roll dead, and that's where West Virginia will take over. Pretty good field position at the 26-yard line. Now they have to turn it into something. They've had some opportunities, but they have yet to solve this Ohio defense. We'll find out if they can get it done here in the second half. The big key for me, you take away the skill position, it's right up front. It's right up
front. It is,
the Ohio defensive line has dominated this football game.
And that's been the case now for 6 or 7 years. I mean, that's been the difference in this run as Ohio tries to win its seventh in a row. This series is not as lopsided as a lot of people think. Since it was the Rudy Mumley event, going back to the early 70s, Ohio has an 18-10 record, but you know, you throw this winning streak out, it was 12-10, mm-hmm. and you go back to the 1940s when this series really originated. Ohio's won 33 of these games. West Virginia has won 21, and there's been one tie. So yeah, there's been a lot of this talk about changing the format. Don't have it, you know, have a north-south. Don't do that. Don't change anything. Look, these things are cyclic. Ohio is naturally, because there are more schools and more talent overall, going to win more games than they lose. But I just don't think anybody would be reaching for any panic buttons or anything. This thing is just fine the way it is.
10:51 to go, third quarter of play, 20-0. Ohio on top, but West Virginia, you know, Coach Jim Rogers is going to make adjustments, and this is a guy that took his team all the way to the state semifinal last year, so this is a guy that can flat-out coach. So if he can come up with something that's going to be a problem for Ohio, he'll find it.
Few schools,
whether or not his players can execute it.
Few schools have enjoyed the overall success the last 3 years that Cameron has, and Jim's done a great job with these kids.
Cardinali up the middle and spins it a little bit to the outside. He'll pick up about 8 yards on first down. Trevor Cooper coming up and getting a piece of the tackle. He was helped out on the play, but a big gain for West Virginia on first down, and if they could pick up 8 every first down, they would be very, very happy, because they have not been able to do it. A look at the Pepsi instant replay.
Good job, as you see a lot of the Ohio defenders get sucked up inside and overrun that play, and Cardinali turns the corner.
Donnie Price is the defensive captain, helped out on that last tackle.
Ooh.
And this one, nothing doing. Coming through is Filtz from Steubenville Big Red. Todd Filtz from Steubenville. And he comes up with a big hit.
Well, now West Virginia gets second and short. One of the few times that they've had that opportunity. And the next thing they wind up with is 3rd and 5 after Ohio comes up with another big penetration right there. Boy, Filtz just knifed through there, unblocked.
Talked to some of the Ohio coaches this week, George, and if you look at Todd Filtz, if you walked up to him, saw him in street clothes, you'd think this is the all-time leading tackler in Steubenville Big Red history.
Exactly.
He is. He is tough from head to toe, not real big, and it looks like Ohio has a turnover, but he will come and hit you like a ton of bricks, and he has done it on the defensive side, and here it looks like Tyler Hill from St. Clairsville, big number 73, has come up with a fumble recovery. And that big interior line getting it done again for Ohio, as the Buckeyes will come out offensively and have a chance to tack on 7 more if they can put it in the end zone against this West Virginia defense.
There's Tyler wearing number 73, a 6'1", 280-pounder. Had a good career at St. C for Mark Boner and company.
Trevor Cooper, lone back in the backfield, option this way. Caldwell will pitch. Cooper with plenty of running room. Cooper to the corner. Stiff arm. He's ridden out of bounds. But a big gain in the first down, down near the 12-yard line for Ohio. Trevor Cooper on the carry. And the Indian Creek Redskin with a nice run. 6'1", 189 pounds of Trevor Cooper.
Yep. And you've got guys like Sowers and Cooper and Kittle with the inside power. Trevor, a real good football player for Indian Creek and a key man in a successful season last year for the Skins.
This time it's Kittle out of Buckeye Trail, and he is stacked up at the line of scrimmage. Coming through for West Virginia, number 17, Josh Rocchio. Rocchio out of Tyler Consolidated.
Another one of those guys you look at, Bill, at 5'9", 160 pounds, you say to yourself, not a real big fella, but you can just tell by the look at him.
He's going to hit you.
Ohio on top here, 20 to nothing. As the cycle begins for the 2001 season, the kids will be out. High school's tomorrow morning, and we'll be looking at them.
Caldwell looking for Materkoski, decides he doesn't have him, and he steps up in the pocket, tries to run out of trouble, but he is taken down in the backfield on the stop. Crhis Horn from Magnolia High School, big number 73, making the stop for the West Virginia All-Stars. It's a loss on the play of about 3 yards.
And you get another look at it. Horn. Good pursuit. And third down and about 12.
8 minutes to go in the third quarter of play, and Caldwell's going to roll to the West Virginia side of the field. He'll tuck it and keep on the run. Hit around the ankles, it looks like, by Wyatt O'Neill, who wears number one. He picks up about 7 or 8 yards. He'll be short of the first down and bring up fourth down, and here comes the field goal unit for Ohio.
Well, earlier, Bill, I said I had a theory as to why maybe West Virginia is struggling a little bit. I think really one of the reasons, in all honesty, is that 17 of the players on their roster are from Class A schools. Those are the small schools. And there, you know, are not that many schools on the West Virginia side of the river to begin with, and a half a dozen of them are Class A. So you're asking a lot of kids that have not played against some of the bigger guys around the valley to do this thing. And there's a nice field goal. And they connect to go up 23-0 right here.
Hughes with the field goal for Ohio, and the Ohio All-Stars now have a 23-0 lead here in the 30th annual Rudy Mumley OVAC All-Star Football Classic on the Trinity Health System scoreboard. Ohio on top, back with more after this. Welcome back to Wheeling Island Stadium on the Trinity Health System scoreboard. Ohio on top, 23-0 over West Virginia. And Ohio will kick the football off here in the third quarter of play. We have 7:20 to go. And, of course, in 7:20, George, chance for a $10,000 win. Paul Birchfield will be down on the field from Toronto, Ohio, trying to win that $10,000. Already a winner. He gets $500, whether he misses it or makes it. But you want the 10 grand as Clayton Fitzsimmons finds the seam on the outside. And he's out to the 40-yard line. And West Virginia excited about that. Hopefully they'll be able to get something started offensively.
Well, I know that there's a lot of pride, some of these West Virginia players. There's a shot of Clayton. What an absolute pepper pot of a player for Wheeling Central this year. Another guy not very big, just a playmaker on both sides of the football for the state champs. You hate to say something like this at this point, Bill, but it's reality. West Virginia is going to be fighting to avert a shutout in this game. They've got to get the ball in the end zone. They're playing for a little bit of pride right now. Trying to win is a tall order when you're down 23-0. Mm-hmm. Just get something humming, get something on the board.
Now they go to the ground on first down. Not much there. A swarming Ohio defense. Pick a number. And the helmet was probably on the ball carrier on first down. Second down and long for West Virginia, and this Ohio defense has been stout.
And it's been that case since the early 90s. Ohio has featured some stellar defensive personnel over the years. In fact, if you look at the scores, Bill, West Virginia has only scored more than 14 points one time in the last, well, since 1993. They were beaten 43-21 in 96. Other than that, they've been shut out a couple of times, beaten 13-7 last year, still stuck on zero here tonight.
Second down and long. Fike will throw, has a man, Toby Brown, and he has it, and it's out of his hands.
Goodness.
At the 30-yard line, looked like he would come up with a spectacular catch as he twisted back to try and catch the ball behind him, but it falls incomplete.
Justin Jeffries, Brian Shaffer, in on the coverage for Buckeye.
Well, what can you say? Toby Brown, the former Cameron Dragon. Third and long again for West Virginia, which has been forced away from any semblance of a running game now.
Jason Baxter split to the far side, and they will look to Baxter. foot race with Sowers in its office hands. Flag on the play, and we may have an interference penalty called against the Ohio All-Stars.
Looked like pretty good coverage. Jake Sowers and Justin Jeffers, who have both been active in the secondary for Ohio, but perhaps somebody got a hand in the back. There you see Jason Baxter, former Magnolia Blue Eagle.
We have a push against Ohio, so it'll be a flag, and it will go against the Ohio All-Stars. West Virginia will have an automatic first down, I should say. Pepsi Instant Replay, another look at it. That's pretty good coverage, George. I don't know. Looked like they were running stride for stride.
I honestly don't know where the interference took place there.
May have happened a little bit earlier on the replay. Officials right down there on the field as this one is knocked down. Looked like Todd Filtz coming in along with Jim Amato. Shadyside and Steubenville meeting at the quarterback.
Amato continues. I mean, he was a force for Shadyside. And that, you know, they could have a good team again this year.
He had a big playoff season for the Tigers.
6'3", 200 pounds. This is a kid that just continues to grow and wreaks havoc right here.
If you can't get to the quarterback, get the arms up in the air, and that's exactly what Ty Fleming and the coaching staff at Shadyside preaches. And Jim Amato apparently was paying attention to that lesson very well.
Shadyside can find a running back even close to his abilities. They will be a force to be reckoned with again this year.
Fike, man wide open. It's dropped, and there was nothing but green grass out in front of the intended receiver, Kyle Coyne from Wheeling Central, and was he wide open, and he had maybe 20 yards before you even saw a red jersey.
I have to admit, now I'm starting to feel the frustration for the West Virginia team because there's a penalty marker down, so we'll see what this is all about.
In a situation like this, and I think we feel the frustration as much as the West Virginia All-Stars as we see pass interference, it's because we cover all of these schools.
Well, we do.
We get to know these kids and the coaches. And
we don't want to see anybody embarrassed in this game.
Not at all.
And the fact is that, look at this. Well,
just one of those
Ohio can do no wrong, and the West Virginia players collectively are just not in sync here. But I mean, a penalty marker gives them a new life again with first down.
Sometimes I think some of the fans around the Valley think that we have a rooting interest one way or the other.
Couldn't care less.
Literally, we want all the teams to do well during the regular season, and especially in an All-Star game, you want to see all of the players perform well. So we definitely start to feel the frustration for the West Virginia side as the ball is on the ground. Amato jumps on it along with Fike, and I think the West Virginia quarterback got on top of it and will remain West Virginia football.
I think there's been a lot of that talk, too, Bill, about changing the format of the game. I think, you know, when Ohio gets on a run like they have the last 6 years and, you know, frankly, for the most part, winning these games fairly handily. Last year's game was a good football game, went right down to the wire. But you start to say, man, you know, let's see a nail biter here. Let's get that thing going and get this crowd into this thing.
Well, we've seen that in Major League Baseball. We've seen it go in cycles
National
where
League,
the National
had,
League, the American League couldn't win. When I was a kid, American League never won the All-Star game.
It was like
game.
21 out of 23 the National League won at one stretch, which you couldn't win 21 out of 23 regular season.
Backside pressure. Fike gets it off. Toby Brown, intended receiver, has it at the 10-yard line, and West Virginia will have a first down and more.
Well, they made a play there, and Toby Brown.
Toby Brown out of Cameron High School.
Had a few frustrating moments up to this point, but this is West Virginia's best scoring opportunity of the night.
First down and 10. Ball on the 11.
TJ Haught, what's up?
All right, we're down here with Coach Rogers. Coach Rogers, you're finally getting ready to, you're close enough to put one on the board. What are you going to do here?
We're going to throw the pass. We're going to throw a pass on and out.
It's nice to know what's coming before the play, Billy.
Here comes Fike to the corner, and it is incomplete. Baxter in a battle down in the corner with Ryan Schaefer from Caldwell High School. Baxter out of Magnolia and it's incomplete. Good coverage on the play from Ohio. TJ, what do we have here on second down?
Coach, second down now. You almost had that one. What are you going to do right here?
Come back with it. Same thing. We're coming back with not the same pass route, but we're going to go to the outside.
All right, TJ Hutt on top of the situation with Coach Jim Rogers. Look for it up in the air again, George. Fike looking for some protection. Here comes the blitz, and he's going to run out of time, and he is down back at the 20-yard line. And credit the defensive backfield on great coverage.
We talked about this earlier, Bill. The thing that impresses me is the pride with which Ohio is playing defense in this football game. They are darned and determined to keep West Virginia out of the end zone. And there's just nothing here that Tyler Fike can do. He's got three guys attacking him right there.
Well, it'll bring up third down and 19.
That's one of those plays where you don't know who gets most of the credit. Is it the coverage or is it the penetration by the line? I think combination of the two things.
Everybody did their job. Fike facing third and 19. West Virginia can pick up a first down inside the one-yard line. Swinging out, Fitzsimmons. Clayton looking for some blockers, has blockers, down to the five, spins down to the four-yard line, still
good
on
effort.
His feet, and they swing him ahead to the two-yard line, so it'll be fourth and maybe a yard for first down, and fourth and two to get into the end zone, and a nice play and nice run from the West Virginia All-Stars.
A well-conceived play by Jim Rogers, and the West Virginia coach is very well executed here. Clayton Fitzsimmons, again showing you his toughness. You won't find a tougher kid his size around here.
TJ, what do you got?
Fourth down here. It's your chance to put it in the end zone. What are you going to do?
Fourth down. If you don't put it in the end zone, you won't start playing defense right there.
Look at that effort.
You can't kick a field goal. You're down 23 points. Jesus, look at Toby.
Fike back to pass right across the middle, and it's knocked away.
What a defensive play. The intended receiver, trying to think, who
looked
is
like
it?
Joe Wallace from Bishop Donahue, number 85. And it was in his hands.
And Jeffers, at the last minute, swatted it out of there.
So close, yet so far. We take another look at it on the Pepsi Instant Replay.
That's just a smart play by Jeffers.
Another look at it, different angle. A little wobbler, but Wallace gets his hands on it. Jeffers comes in and gives him a shot. He can't hang on.
West Virginia turned away again.
Oh, Caldwell into the secondary, still on his feet and taken down out of the 20-yard line. Just going to run a little quarterback keeper to get some yardage away from the line of scrimmage and away from the end zone. But instead, it turns into about a 20-yard gain for Crhis Caldwell, and he has had a super ball game. And he will leave the game now. And Matt Materkoski, who has had a big day receiving, is now your quarterback, and maybe Don Sloan can get a word with Crhis Caldwell as he's over on the sideline as Materkoski takes over first and 10 from the 20.
Team up, baby, team up.
Good job by West Virginia's defense. Kevin Cox from Weir High, a 6-foot, 250-pounder, beat his man.
We've got the first annual Fall Brawl, November 10th, 2001, in St. John Arena. Open wrestling tournament, grades K through 12. For more information, call 740-278-8015 or log on the web, www.smittysfloors.com. And it's Smitty's Wholesale Carpet Warehouse that's putting on the Fall Brawl, November 10th, 2001, at St. John Arena. Open wrestling tournament for kindergarten through 12th grade. Come on out to the arena and get involved as we take a look at Brian Kittle, who is from Buckeye Trail, and the fullback who's had a nice game blocking and running with the football for the Ohio All-Stars. A little shaken up on the play. Kittle may look to get a blow on the sideline.
Kittle might have turned an ankle when the second series of players got to him there. There's Materkoski, who had a stellar career at Bellaire.
In the gun, plenty of time, looks to the outside, has a man open, pulled in at the 40-yard line, 45, still on his feet. Trevor Shaffer, and he's finally hauled down at the 48-yard line. It'll be a first down for Ohio as they have it first and 10 at the 48.
Well, here's something interesting. Shaffer from Beallsville, so you've had Materkoski, the Bellaire quarterback, on the receiving end of a lot of Beallsville passes. Now you've got a Beallsville receiver on the receiving end of a Materkoski aerial.
Pepsi instant replay, reverse angle. Shaffer hauls it in.
Materkoski's got a chance to set some kind of a record in this game, Bill, for passing and receiving.
I would imagine he's already set it. He's got two completions, and he has five catches. He's looking for more here. Zips one in to Jake Sowers at the 45-yard line, down to the 40, another first down. Materkoski comes in, zip, zip, right down the field, and the Ohio offense doesn't lose a beat.
And it's a little different look in what they're doing in the passing game. Now out of the shotgun, Materkoski throwing, you know, a little bit of the underneath stuff with a little bit more on it. You know, mm-hmm. The one thing that Caldwell did a brilliant job was throwing that fade, just kind of tossing it up, let Materkoski make an athletic play.
10 seconds until the end of the third quarter and the $10,000 kick. Ohio, first and 10. Ball on the West Virginia 40. Materkoski decides, I'll just run it. He's across the 30, down to the 25-yard line with another first down as the third quarter runs out. And it will go to the fourth quarter with Ohio on top, 23-0 after three quarters of play here in the 30th annual Rudy Mumley OVAC All-Star Football Game. We'll take a timeout and come back with our $10,000 kick right after this. Welcome back to the WTOV9 OVAC All-Star Football Game. Live coverage from WTOV9, 23-0 here at the beginning of the fourth quarter. But right now we need to go down to the field and check in with Kelly Alexia, who's getting ready for a $10,000 kick. Kelly?
Welcome back, everyone, to WTOV9's live exclusive coverage of the 30th annual Rudy Mumley OVAC All-Star Football Classic. We're having a wonderful time here tonight, and the fun continues. We are going to have the health plan's $10,000 kick in just a moment. But first, we're going to honor a very special friend of the Ohio Valley Athletic Conference. He's been integral in making this such a huge event each and every year. Bob Cook, also known as Cookie, will be presenting this award to Ron Mock.
We have a plaque here for Ron. This is his 20th year he's been associated with the All-Star Game. And last year, he kind of resigned as the game director, but now he's the game advisor. But we have some pictures from the past for him to relieve a lot of memories.
Congratulations, Ron Mock. I don't know if we can get a close picture of that. It actually shows Rudy and Sam Mumley, along with Ron Mock. Ron, any words tonight?
This is totally unnecessary.
Are you surprised?
Shocked.
Are you honored?
Very much so.
Do you like what the game has done over the past 25 years?
It's one of the greatest things going in America, and we're blessed that it happens right here in the Valley. We have great people, great athletes, and we have a lot of people that really love kids.
And we love you, Ron Mock. Congratulations to Ron Mock. Hey, our fun continues. We have a special drawing now.
Hold on. We have to introduce the West Virginia All-Stars.
Oh, go ahead.
Thanks, Kelly.
Bill, up back to you.
Kelly, thank you very much. Well, we are getting ready for the $10,000 kick. Well, Saturday at noon, live on WTOV9, Daniel Frizzy and Norm Jones. They're going to go back to school. We'll let you know all the whys and what fors and what parents should be looking for as kids get ready to go back to school. Right here on WTOV9. That's coming up Saturday at noon live on Can we believe we're talking about back to school?
Yep. It's August is upon us, and the kids are going to be getting ready to go back to school. And, you know, the football players are going to go back to work
first thing tomorrow morning.
We'll have our high school football preview starting this week. George Kellis out and about along with his trusty photographer, Del Bears. And right now we're going to send it back to Kelly Alexia.
The first winner will get season tickets to the Ohio State University football games. The winner of that is Ed Nicholson of Spencer, West Virginia. So congratulations to Ed. Oh, wait, did I hear some boos out there? They get us in Spencer, don't they? Okay, now for the season tickets for WVU. Michael Briggs of Martins Ferry, Ohio. Yay! You guys like that one a little bit better, right? Okay, and third and finally, the winner of OVAC season passes, Helen Marie Grimm of Toronto, Ohio. Woo!
And tell them the OVAC will get in contact.
And the OVAC will be getting in contact with you if you did win here tonight. Now we're going to take our show over here. This is where the big moment is. We've been waiting for this for a whole year. This right here is Paul Birchfield of Toronto, Ohio. We like to call him Birch. There's your crowd over there. Let's hear it for Paul. Okay, have you been practicing?
A little bit.
You think you're gonna make this?
Yes, I do.
Okay, it's the health plan, $10,000 kick. Are you ready for this?
Yes, I am.
Am I making you nervous?
No.
Okay, you ready to do it?
Yeah.
Okay, let's wish him luck. Let's hear it for Paul. Check.
Congratulations, Paul. I'd rather give you the $10,000. We haven't done this since the first year, but great effort.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Anything you want to say to your fans over there?
Yeah, thanks for coming.
All right, Paul, good job. And we're going to pitch it back to Bill Phillips.
Kelly, thank you very much. Paul Birchfield, just a bit short. And I'll tell you what, anyone out there that wants to see how tough that is, go out, pace off 35 yards from the goal line, set your ball up, try and kick it through 45 yards, a long way to kick a football.
If you kick one, you kick
one. I've made one from that distance, but that is a long, long way. West Virginia. I'll get my tongue working here. West Virginia Derby celebration live on WTOB9, August 11th at 7 p.m. from the Mountaineer Racetrack and Gaming Resort. Of course, every night of the week, other than Wednesday and Thursday, when the ponies don't run, it's featured race night, race number 8 from the Mountaineer Racetrack and Game Resort. We have some fun with that. We're going to have a lot of fun with the West Virginia Derby celebration live August 11th at 7 p.m. right here on WTOV9. And hopefully I'll be able to say West and Virginia together better that night than I have in this last 30 seconds.
One thing happened there during all of that, Bill. I want to get to, here's Materkoski in her center, but something interesting happened, and we'll get back to it.
Well, Crhis Caldwell in at running back now.
Dave Caldwell has thrown all kinds of different wrinkles into this. But you had a guy from Spencer, West Virginia, win season tickets to Ohio State games, and a guy from Martins Ferry win season tickets to West Virginia games. You think they might want to get together and swap?
I was going to say, they're somewhere under the stands making a deal. We could go down and broker that deal. Maybe we could get a cut of the action.
Well, that's a haul from Spencer to Columbus, trust me.
Hand off to Caldwell, the quarterback. Now at running back, he's still on his feet, finally knocked out of bounds at about the 15-yard line. He'll be close to a first down. They may have to measure that one, but it will be close. Want to mention this as we head down first to T.J. Hott. T.J.?
Thanks, Bill. Coach Rogers is a little bit upset, a little bit disappointed He's very proud of his kids. He said they've been playing their hearts out, but they failed to do the three things that they set forth to do at the beginning of the game, and that was control the line of scrimmage. They've done a very bad job of that. They've just been overpowered on the line. They haven't been able to control the clock because of the, you know, not being able to control the line, of course, and they haven't been able to stop the pass. Crhis Caldwell and Matt Materkoski both had good games. Both receiving, running, passing, they've been doing it all. And but Coach Rogers is very proud of his team. He just wished that it was a little bit better, a little bit better on the scoreboard side.
TJ, thank you very much. TJ Hott down on the West Virginia sideline. Don Sloan somewhere down on the Ohio sideline as Ohio trying to punch another score in. They lead it 23-0. Matt Materkoski with Jake Sowers in the backfield, along with Crhis Caldwell. And Sowers up the middle. He's to the five, he's to the two, he's to the one, and he's finally stopped at about the one-yard line. So it'll bring up first thing goal for Ohio from the one. Don Sloan?
Well, Coach Caldwell running Jake Sowers on that play, but before that, running it, but Crhis Caldwell, the quarterback at tailback, he's even make a running game interesting, Dave.
First play, tailback and every other thing.
Well, we got that Brian Kittle boy hurt, and we didn't really hurt it. I didn't really work anybody in there, and I knew he knew the plays. So that's why he's in there right now.
Well, what will we run here?
A dive play to Jake Sowers, and he fumbled the ball.
How about a sneak by Materkoski?
Sneak by Materkoski? You don't even know what you're running, do you?
I got an audible there for that. Materkoski wanted a touchdown, so I guess he took it.
You know what? It worked, though. It worked. That makes it 29-0, and Kellis is giving you rough time. You have anything to say to Kellis?
Hey, Don, I'll tell you what. You're going to get one of those one-liners in. He's going to pop you one.
Either.
Let me tell you.
I don't know, Dave.
29-0, Ohio on top of West Virginia. Brian Kittle, who's a little bit banged up from Buckeye Trail, he is back in the ball game, and he will be blocking on the extra point attempt. The kick is up, and the kick is plenty long enough, high enough, and it is good.
Well, thanks to Caldwell and Sloan, I've gotten a lot of entertainment out of this. Look at this. Materkoski, in terms of passing, running, and receiving, has got to be piling up some kind of yardage here, and I'd have to go back probably to Tim Spencer, 1979, when he was a man amongst boys in this building. It was another great performance by John Henry Martin back in 1955 from Wellsville, and of course he would go on to play for the Wheeling Ironmen.
But I'm talking about a triple threat.
Oh my God! And you're looking now at West Virginia. They're frustrated. Look to next year, if you will.
Mm-hmm.
They will put together the best all-star team that they have in quite a few years. They're going to have Justin Edwards from Wheeling Central. They're going to have Monteleone, the quarterback, from John Marshall. Wheeling Park and Brooke are talent-laden teams coming back with a lot of seniors this coming season. So if you're a West Virginia fan, look ahead. Next year, there will be more talent on this field wearing gold and blue than there has been in quite some time. But then again, Ohio will always be talent-laden, so that doesn't guarantee it.
It always sets up for some interesting talk around the water cooler.
There have been so many things, Bill. I mean, you've had the Caldwell kid who's passed for over 200 yards, running the football, caught a pass. He and Materkoski, between the two of them, have to have accounted for a tremendous, probably 400 or 500 yards between them in this game.
Clayton Fitzsimmons on the return out to the 20-yard line. We're having a lot of fun, and it's a lot of fun in games as high school football comes, but some serious things to talk about. And the American Red Cross, when there's a disaster, the American Red Cross is there. Disaster relief efforts for Southern West Virginia. Send donations to the Ohio Valley Chapter, American Red Cross, 193 29th Street, Wheeling, West Virginia, 26003. Or visit www.redcross.org. Southern West Virginia Disaster Relief for all of the flooding. Again, the address, Ohio Valley Chapter, American Red Cross, 193 29th Street, Wheeling, West Virginia, 26003. Or visit the web at www.redcross.org. All of the help is welcome.
Nice catch. Materkoski from Wheeling Central, who was an integral part of the Wheeling Central offense, CJ, at 6'3", 225. Every time somebody makes a catch, though, for West Virginia, an Ohio defender makes them pay for it. And you're going to see the big stick back here, I think, courtesy of Jeffers, who's been all over the secondary making plays here tonight.
Don Sloan, take it away.
And George, that's a good point. Justin Jeffers, what a game tonight. He had a couple interceptions that didn't count. One was due to a penalty. And he broke up the big pass play in the end zone, another key play there. We've talked a lot about the Ohio's offense, but Jeffers and his defense, they've been outstanding tonight.
Don, thank you very much. Incomplete pass.
Nice post slant right there, but they couldn't hook up on it. The intended receiver for West Virginia was Toby Brown. Third and a yard.
Tyler Fike has gone the entire way for the West Virginia All-Stars at quarterback out of Wheeling Park High School. Third and short, he'll look to throw, slips, and coming off the corner, Todd Filtz from Steubenville High School, the big red linebacker, making the sack. There's a good look at Todd Filtz. 5'7", 175, but I'll tell you what, he'll hit you in the mouth as soon as talk to you.
Between he and Fitzsimmons,
yep,
those are a couple of powder kegs and small packages right there. Those are sticks of dynamite, these two guys.
Good look at Todd. Had a great career at Steubenville Big Red. West Virginia in punt formation. Almost blocked. Good kick. It's away, and Shaffer will take it and just cover up at the 43-yard line.
West Virginia on that series, Bill, had third and one. And on third down, I think they just lost confidence in their ability to run for short yardage inside. Fike went back to throw the football and lost his footing, and here is Ohio again with good field position. So at this point, with Ohio leading in this game 30 to nothing, it becomes a mercy factor.
Trevor Cooper in the backfield along with Crhis Caldwell. On the wing for Ohio, Trevor Shaffer. Nothing fancy, just a pitch to the outside. Cooper has about five on first down.
Trevor Cooper, ball carrier.
There's Trevor. I don't know who it was that put these graphics together for this, but whoever it was did a brilliant job.
Teresa Gretchen back at the station, one of the directors of WTOV9, put a lot of extra time in, a lot of great support from the production department at WTOV9. You'll see their names at the end of this telecast, and they have done a great job with the production. Teresa put a lot of time in. Matt Babb also worked on those graphics, and we want to thank everybody at WTOV9. It's truly a station effort. You see the faces that you normally see, myself and George, Don, TJ, Ryan Recker, Kelly Alexiou, but it's really an effort of the entire station. A lot of people that you don't hear from or see on front of the in front of the camera, and they do a fantastic job. Another group that does a great job, as we have another running play, is the group from Image Video that helps us with our high school football games every year. Dean Marini leading that group. He's directing the game tonight. We want to thank everyone from Image Video. They always do such a wonderful job. So a lot of work goes on with this football game behind the scenes here at Wheeling Island Stadium, of course, throughout the high school football season. So thank you very much to everybody that puts in all the work as we take a look at Aaron Poling from Cameron High School, 6'1", 185 pounds. And what we understand now, we have learned that TJ has some information on the story on the helmet and the name Lauren across the front of the helmet. TJ?
Thanks, Bill. Of course, many of the Ohio Valley residents know Lauren Lemons, the girl from Cameron who passed away of meningitis. She passed away on the same date as Cameron's high school graduation. Aaron Poling, very good friends with her, very close to her. He said this game is dedicated to her.
Trevor Cooper, the ball carrier.
All right, Trevor Cooper gets the carry for the Ohio All-Stars. And he is down to the 25-yard line of West Virginia. Don Sloan joins me in the booth now. What did they kick you off the sidelines? What happened to you down there? They got had about enough of you. Dave Caldwell tired of you calling plays for him.
Dave Caldwell threw me off the sideline. That's about it.
Here's the pitch. And another good gain down to the 16-yard line. Trevor Cooper, the workhorse on this series for Ohio. 30-0, the Ohio All-Stars lead West Virginia. George Kellis here along with Bill Phillips, Don Sloan. We had Ryan Recker, TJ Hott, Kelly Alexia, and the rest of the gang here.
Hey, we've got the whole team out tonight ready to kick off the season, and kind of hard to believe it's here. Practice gets underway tomorrow.
And there is Caldwell, the ball carrier again. Caldwell, passing and rushing, has a lot of yards. Materkoski, passing, rushing, and receiving, has a lot of yards.
And if you look at Caldwell, how about this? There he is, 6 foot, 205 pounds, playing tailback tonight as well. But look back at the high school season. This guy played nose guard and quarterback. Caldwell, one heck of an athlete out of Beallsville.
And they continue to try to run some time off the clock here, obviously. Ohio with matters well in hand. West Virginia All-Stars just outmanned here tonight. What time? How much time we got left there, Phil?
4:50 to go here in the fourth quarter of play.
I've got 8 minutes
and a timeout. 30-0 with 4:40 to go in the fourth quarter of play. We take a look at the Trinity Health System scoreboard. 30-0 Ohio over West Virginia. And welcome back to the OVAC All-Star Game. It's the 30th Rudy Mumley All-Star Football Classic here at Wheeling Island Stadium. Unfortunately, this year, as we take a look at Wheeling Island Gaming, that's where the puppies run over across the way.
That's the new facility at Wheeling Downs. And here are the Ohio All-Stars knocking at the door to the 4-yard line, penalty marker on top of it all. Caldwell, the ball carrier.
Aaron Pulling is off the play. Flag on the field.
Well, Billy, this was not the biggest turnout on the West Virginia side that I've ever seen, and right now it's gotten a little sparser.
This game needs to end.
Well, people starting to head home. It is getting to about the 10 o'clock hour, and this one pretty much wrapped up at this point with Ohio on top 30-0. Trevor Cooper, Crhis Caldwell in the backfield, Matt Materkoski still under center, scored the last Ohio touchdown. Caldwell gets into the end zone for a touchdown. So the quarterback that has thrown for a couple scores is now into the end zone on the run, and that will make him 36-0. Ohio on top. And another excessive celebration penalty against the Ohio All-Stars. Take another look at it on the Pepsi instant replay. Just a little handoff, a little dive play. And the offensive line getting the job done up front for the Ohio All-Stars.
So it's 36-0, and Ohio will have to attempt a lengthy conversion once again.
Hughes on to attempt the extra point, has a fine leg, but you hate to see it when you're kicking an extra point. You just push it back. Okay, this isn't a chip shot anymore. Not that any extra points are really chip shots. You have to get the snap, the hold, and everything else to work just right. But you never like to add an additional 10 yards or so onto the extra point attempt as 4:12 left to go in the game, 36-0, Ohio on top here in the fourth quarter.
So again, the only suspense that's left here would be to see if West Virginia can get some points on the board and avert a shutout. And of course, if you're looking at it from the Buckeyes' perspective, they are playing with a great deal of pride on defense and would like to record that shutout and be remembered as one of those outstanding defensive units to play in this game.
He hooked that one a little bit too much, got a little over anxious, tried to put a little too much mustard on it, pulled it left, and it'll remain 36-0. Ohio on top on the Trinity Health System scoreboard. Ohio 36, West Virginia nothing. 4:12 to go in the ball game. Donnie Price, linebacker for Ohio, defensive captain. Well, the price is right, and I guess the number's 40. Of course, you don't want to go higher than the right number, so congratulations to Donnie Price out of Toronto High School. He's got his fan club ready to go. Some pictures being taken of the cameraman taking pictures of them.
I was going to say, I wish I had a fan club that looked like that when I was in high school.
You see number 40, Donnie Price, one of the defensive captains this year out of Toronto High School. Toronto, another great season last year as they went into the postseason and continued along that road towards the state championship. Unfortunately, coming up a little bit short, but has that program really caught fire the last few years? 36-0 as West Virginia returns the kick. It'll be down at the 20-yard line, and that's where it'll take over with 4:06 to go. Simon Sidkavich.
West Virginia, they take over first down and 10. Ball on their own 20.
A look at Jim Rogers, who has not had many frustrating events on the gridiron the last couple, 3 years, but this is one I'm sure he's going to want to forget in a hurry. Get right back to work with the Dragons.
Fike to pass, swings it out to Toby Brown. Nice move. Picks up about 5-6 yards, maybe even 7 on first down. That will be second down and 3 for the West Virginia All-Stars. Fike to Brown. Speaking of the Cameron Dragons, Brown out of camera. We'll take a look at the replay, Pepsi Instant Replay. Brown with a nice move. Filtz over pursues. Coming up and cleaning up on the tackle, big number 73, Tyler Hill, out of St. Clairsville.
Ball carrier.
Third down and 2 here, Billy. 36-0 in favor of the Ohio All-Stars.
Ohio looking to post their 7th straight win, and they are well on their way with just 2:55 left to go in the ball game.
And if West Virginia doesn't keep this drive alive on this play, they may not get the ball back.
Down the middle, Brown in and out of his hands and incomplete.
Well, in all honesty, they got to go for it here.
Let's take a look at the high school schedule coming up on WTOV9, the game of the week. We're in Oak Glen on August 24th. Brooke and Steubenville, Big Red on the 31st. September 1st, Buckeye Local Martins, Ferry, John Marshall, and Bellaire on the 1st of September. September 7th, Steubenville Catholic against Martins Ferry. Brooke and Weir on the 14th of September. St. Clairsville and Bellaire on the 15th. Wheeling Park and Edison on the 21st of September. September 22nd, Wheeling Central and Wellsville. September 28th, Barnesville and Shadyside. Martins Ferry and Indian Creek on October 5th. October 12th, another big ball game for Big Red and Buckeye Local. They will meet on the field again, Edison and Indian Creek, on October 13th on the 19th. East Liverpool and Steubenville Big Red, that's turned into a nice rivalry. Barnesville and Union Local on October 26th, October 27th. It's Toronto and Steubenville Catholic Central. And while you catch your breath after that one, we've got a timeout down on the field. And of course, with 2 minutes and 37 seconds, it's important to take a timeout with the score 36 to nothing. Just thought I'd add that in.
Yeah, and it's going to be fourth down and two in West Virginia, obviously with one thing in mind.
George, I know you're ready to sit down and get some good Italian food in your belly, and we can do that August 22nd down at Undo's West in St. Clairsville. Come on out and join us for that one at Undo's West, the high school football preview show. And we will have interviews with local high school coaches. We'll take a look back at all the high school previews as we get ready to kick off the season on that Friday night. Of course, on Friday night, what better place to be than WTOV9 as we have our Sports Friday Football Edition. Ryan Recker, Bill Phillips, Don Sloan, George Kellis, and TJ Hott joining the group. And of course, we have the Queen of Queens pageant August 4th at 1 p.m. on WTOV9. Kelly Alexi along with Bill Phillip. I'm not sure who he is, but someone dropped my ass. Dean Marini with a comment we won't repeat on air.
And look at this, the blocked punt now. And
Jake Sowers will pick it up at the 21-yard line.
Well, I got to, you know, just toss in this question here. I mean, you're fourth and two. You're trying to avert a shutout. And if you don't go for it in that situation, you're throwing up a white flag and saying, okay, well, let's just get out of here. So the Buckeye defense and special teams and the whole package is together because now they busted up a punt.
2:28 left to go in the ball game. 36 to nothing, Ohio on top. First and 10 from the 19-yard line. And it looks like Ohio may take the victory formation. And indeed they will. Trevor Shaffer, number 20, back at the 30-yard line. Snap, kneel, and the clock will run. And we go down onto the field with TJ Hott. TJ?
Thanks, Bill. Coach, not exactly the way you had it scripted, but what do you think?
Well, they hurt us the two plays I worried the most about. They're bigger than our line. They controlled us at the line of scrimmage. In the passing game. There's the two things I was concerned about going into this game, and we thought we had a plan for it, but I'll give Dave credit. You know, he did a nice job with their defense. They took our trap game away from us. They took our outside game with us. So, my fault.
Your kids played their heart out. What do you tell them after the game?
Hey, good job. I mean, what can you tell them? These kids played a hell of a ball game, but I'll take the blame for the loss. I'm not gonna put it, I wouldn't put the blame on any of these kids if you're darn two good kids. But they physically whipped us. That was obvious.
All right, thanks, Coach.
Yeah.
Bill?
In defense, Bill, of Coach Rogers there, I mean, he can take the blame if he wants to, but in all reality, there are just times in sports when you're just overmatched. I mean, there's nobody at fault here. You know, give Ohio credit. They're playing a whale of a game. It's not that West Virginia's doing anything wrong. Ohio just has better football players.
And I think he analyzed the game correctly. So, you know, the offensive line, he was worried about that coming into the ball game. He's off worried about the two lines, and that's what happened. As we take a look at Smitty's Carpet Wholesale, sponsoring the cheerleader cam, we'll call it, as we take a look at the Ohio cheerleaders, the All-Stars from the Buckeye State, of course, is West Virginia cheerleaders. We'll take a look at them one more time before the clock runs down. 51 seconds to go in the ball game. Fourth and 12 now for Ohio, and they will still just kneel on the ball as we take a look at the All-Stars from West Virginia and the Smitty's Wholesale Carpet cheerleader camp.
A spirited group of young ladies, despite what has been a very difficult evening for West Virginia fans here tonight.
Well, we have about 38 seconds to go in the ball game. Maybe Don Sloan can grab Coach Caldwell, get a wrap up of his thoughts on tonight's ball game. Don?
Coach Caldwell, great game.
Hey guys, I got to go to a thing tonight. I don't have any dry clothes.
He's got to go to a thing tonight. Coach, before you go to the thing, good effort by your, what thing?
Well,
The fifth quarter we have to go to, and I don't have any dry clothes, and I don't want to get soaked.
Well, you'll be happy going to your third time coaching, first win. So this time you'll be happy going.
Oh, I'm happy all the time. Everybody's a winner in this game, and I'm just sorry there had to be a losing team, but the kids at the Children's Hospital will benefit from this game.
Good effort by your kids. I mean, offensively, good show with Caldwell and Materkoski. What a connection.
Oh, yeah, two great athletes. You know, we wanted to get both of them on the field at the same time. That was part of the game. And I don't want to stand here and let you.
I don't want to get dunked either. But, and defensively, outstanding job. I think you guys really put pressure on them out up front, and it really disrupted their offense in the early going.
Oh, yes, it did. That was our game plan. We wanted to get up there and get some heat on them right off the bat. We had two good kids in there that could really get through there quick, and we just wanted to get up there and get that accomplished, and we did.
Well, looks like the Cat in the Hat has been doused. Coach Dave Caldwell gets the water bath. Back up to you guys.
All right, now bring it back to try and keep it. I'm going to try and,
how much time's left, Billy? I can't see around the corner.
38 seconds to go in the ball game. Ohio and West Virginia. 36-0 as West Virginia comes out of their huddle. They'll have it first and 10 from the 23-yard line.
There is the hatless Cat in the Hat. Where they try to get him with the, it looks like he's a little wet on the backside there, so something tells me they did try to get him with the.
They got him with a little Gatorade bottle, just a little soak. Fike back to pass. Looking long down the seam, Toby Brown has it at the 45 and down to the 40-yard line.
That was a great catch from West Virginia. Kellis wants to know what's up with the hat, though. He says, you're one of the few coaches remaining who doesn't wear headsets. He says, you wear these Chichi Rodriguez golf hats. What's up with that?
Well, when it gets real hot in the summer, I don't have much hair up there, and I like to have something to keep me shaded, and it just makes me a little cooler. That's the only thing behind it.
There's your answer, Kellis.
You know, when I met Dave Caldwell in 1984, he was a young coach over there, we both had a lot more hair.
What's that?
What is going? What is the, with the
11 seconds to go, and we have a timeout. Score 36-0, Ohio on top on the Trinity Health System scoreboard. And with 11 seconds to go, Tyler Fike says, you know what, I want to have the right play. We want to get on the board. So he calls a quick timeout. West Virginia will talk things over, and then they will look to get in the end zone. I want to mention to everybody, this fall, first to be annual fall brawl, November 10th, 2001, St. John Arena. Open wrestling tournament, grades K through 12. For more information, call 740-278-8015 or log on to www.smittyscarpet.com for more information on the wrestling tournament. Toby Brown, little swing pass. Down to 10 seconds. He's got to pitch it. He's got to keep it alive. And with 2 seconds to go, he'll be knocked down. Clock runs out. And that will do it for the 2001 edition of the OVAC All-Star Football Game here on Wheeling Island Stadium. The 30th annual Ohio, the final score, 36-0. Ohio on top of West Virginia. There's a look at your final score. The Ohio Valley Athletic Conference OVAC All-Star Football Game. 36-0 Ohio on top. We are proud and happy to bring it to you live on WTOV9. Don Sloan is down on the field with Matt Materkoski at a big game. Don?
Thanks a lot, guys. Matt Materkoski, a key player tonight. Offensive totals, unbelievable for you. And normally quarterback, how did you feel coming out playing a wideout? Have you ever done that before?
No, I just came out, just tried to get in the flow of thing, get a couple passes, and hopefully I just got in the flow of the game.
You and Caldwell really seemed to click. Did you work out a lot at wideout this week, or was it a surprise tonight?
We've been working it all week, getting our routes down and everything, and timing patterns down.
You like playing wideout, maybe you don't get hit quite as much.
No, I like quarterback.
Matt Materkoski, back up to you guys.
Don, thank you very much. As we take a look at the field with the players congratulating each other on a good game and a safe game. No major injuries to speak of 36-0 Ohio on top of West Virginia here at Wheeling Island Stadium, the 30th annual Rudy Mumley OVAC All-Star Game has come to a conclusion with Ohio on top of West Virginia. Ohio now winning seven straight All-Star Games here at Wheeling Island Stadium. Don Sloan down on the field along with T.J. Haught. Kelly Alexia down on the field tonight as well. Myself, George Kellis, and Ryan Recker up in the booth. We'd like to thank everybody from WTOV9 and Image Video for bringing this broadcast to you. Thanks to everybody. And once again, we say goodnight and we get ready for the 2001 high school football season in the Ohio Valley. It's going to be a great one, everybody. Make sure you're here watching WTOV9. We'll bring you all of the action throughout the 2001 season. Until next time, I'm Bill Phillips for the rest of the WTOV9 team. Have a great night.